you're listening to this. You are the resistance.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis uccelli et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini.
The obscure of the earth, mean and ignoble wretches have been filled, that is, enriched, with houses of iniquity, that is, with our estates and possessions, which they have unjustly acquired. Let not the humble be turned away with confusion, the poor and needy shall praise thy name. Arise, O God, judge thy own cause, remember thy reproaches with which the foolish man hath reproached thee all the day. Forget not the voices of thy enemies, the pride of them that hate thee ascendeth continually. Confit bimur tibi. There is a just judgment to come, therefore let the wicked take care. Unto the end, corrupt not, a psalm of a canticle for Asaph. We will praise thee, O God, we will praise, and we will call upon thy name. We will relate thy wondrous works, when I shall take a time, I will judge justices. The earth is melted, and all that dwell therein, I have established the pillars thereof. I said to the wicked, do not act wickedly, and to the sinners, lift not up the horn. Corrupt not, it is believed to have been the beginning of some ode or hymn, to the tune of which this psalm was to be sung. Saint Augustine and other fathers take it to be an admonition of the Spirit of God, not to faint or fail in our hope, but to persevere with constancy in good, because God will not fail in his due time to render to every man according to his works. When I shall take a time, in proper times, particularly at the last day, when the earth shall melt away at the presence of the great judge, the same who originally laid the foundations of it, and as it were established its pillars. Lift not up your horn on high, speak not iniquity against God. For neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the desert hills, for God is the judge. One he putteth down, and another he lifteth up, for in the hand of the Lord there is a cup of strong wine full of mixture. And he hath poured it out from this to that, but the dregs thereof are not emptied, all the sinners of the earth shall drink. But I will declare forever, I will sing to the God of Jacob. And I will break all the horns of sinners, but the horns of the just shall be exalted. Notice in Judea. God is known in his church, and exerts his power in protecting it. It alludes to the slaughter of the Assyrians, in the days of King Ezekias. Unto the end, in praises, a psalm for Asaph, a canticle to the Assyrians. In Judea God is known, his name is great in Israel. And his place is in peace, and his abode in Sion. There hath he broken the powers of bows, the shield, the sword, and the battery. Thou enlightenest wonderfully from the everlasting hills. All the foolish of heart were troubled. They have slept their sleep, and all the men of riches have found nothing in their hands. At thy rebuke, O God of Jacob, they have all slumbered that mounted on horseback. Thou art terrible, and who shall resist thee? From that time thy wrath. Thou hast caused judgment to be heard from heaven, the earth trembled and was still, when God arose in judgment, to save all the meek of the earth. From that time, from the time that thy wrath shall break out. For the thought of man shall give praise to thee, and the remainders of the thought shall keep holiday to thee. Vow ye, and pay to the Lord your God, all you that are round about him bring presents. To him that is terrible, even to him who taketh away the spirit of princes, to the terrible with the kings of the earth. Vocem me. The faithful have recourse to God in trouble of mind, with confidence in his mercy and power. Unto the end, for Adaidhun, a psalm of Asaph. I cried to the Lord with my voice, to God with my voice, and he gave ear to me. In the day of my trouble I sought God, with my hands lifted up to him in the night, and I was not deceived. My soul refused to be comforted, I remembered God, and was delighted, and was exercised, and my spirit swooned away. My eyes prevented the watches, I was troubled, and I spoke not. I thought upon the days of old, and I had in my mind the eternal years. And I meditated in the night with my own heart, and I was exercised and I swept my spirit. Will God then cast off forever? Or will he never be more favorable again? Or will he cut off his mercy forever, from generation to generation? Or will God forget to show mercy? Or will he in his anger shut up his mercies? And I said, now have I begun, this is the change of the right hand of the Most High. I remembered the works of the Lord, for I will be mindful of thy wonders from the beginning. And I will meditate on all thy works, and will be employed in thy inventions. Thy way, O God, is in the holy place, who is the great God like our God. Thou art the God that dost wonders. thou hast made thy power known among the nations. With thy arm thou hast redeemed thy people, the children of Jacob and of Joseph. The waters saw thee, O God, the waters saw thee, and they were afraid, and the depths were troubled. Great was the noise of the waters, the clouds sent out a sound. For thy arrows pass, the voice of thy thunder and the wheel. Thy lightnings enlightened the world, the earth shook and trembled. Thy way is in the sea, and thy paths in many waters, and thy footsteps shall not be known. Thou hast conducted thy people like sheep, by the hand of Moses and Aaron. Attentite. God's great benefits to the people of Israel, notwithstanding their ingratitude. Understanding for Asaph. Attend, O my people, to my law, incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in parables, I will utter propositions from the beginning. How great things have we heard and known, and our fathers have told us. They have not been hidden from their children, in another generation. Declaring the praises of the Lord, and his powers, and his wonders which he hath done. And he set up a testimony in Jacob, and made a law in Israel. How great things he commanded our fathers, that they should make the same known to their children. Propositions, deep and mysterious sayings. By this it appears that the historical facts of ancient times, commemorated in this psalm, were deep and mysterious, as being figures of great truths appertaining to the time of the New Testament. That another generation might know them. The children that should be born and should rise up, and declare them to their children. That they may put their hope in God and may not forget the works of God, and may seek his commandments. That they may not become like their fathers, a perverse and exasperating generation. A generation that set not their heart aright, and whose spirit was not faithful to God. The sons of Ephraim who bend and shoot with the bow, they have turned back in the day of battle. They kept not the covenant of God, and in his law they would not walk. And they forgot his benefits, and his wonders that he had shown them. Wonderful things did he do in the sight of their fathers, in the land of Egypt, in the field of Tanis. He divided the sea and brought them through, and he made the waters to stand as in a vessel. And he conducted them with a cloud by day, and all the night with a light of fire. He struck the rock in the wilderness, and gave them to drink, as out of the great deep. He brought forth water out of the rock, and made streams run down as rivers. And they added yet more sin against him, they provoked the Most High to wrath in the place without water. And they tempted God in their hearts, by asking meat for their desires. And they spoke ill of God, they said, "Can God furnish a table in the wilderness?" Because he struck the rock, and the waters gushed out, and the streams overflowed. Can he also give bread, or provide a table for his people? Therefore the Lord heard, and was angry, and a fire was kindled against Jacob, and wrath came up against Israel. Because they believed not in God, and trusted not in his salvation. And he had commanded the clouds from above, and had opened the doors of heaven. And had rained down manna upon them to eat, and had given them the bread of heaven. Man ate the bread of angels, he sent them provisions in abundance. He removed the south wind from heaven, and by his power brought in the southwest wind. And he rained upon them flesh as dust, and feathered fowls like as the sand of the sea. And they fell in the midst of their camp, round about their pavilions. So they did eat, and were filled exceedingly, and he gave them their desire. They were not defrauded of that which they craved. As yet their meat was in their mouth. And the wrath of God came upon them. And he slew the fat ones amongst them, and brought down the chosen men of Israel. In all these things they sinned still, and they believed not for his wondrous works. And their days were consumed in vanity, and their years in haste. When he slew them, then they sought him, and they returned, and came to him early in the morning. And they remembered that God was their helper, and the Most High God their Redeemer. And they loved him with their mouth, and with their tongue they lied unto him, but their heart was not right with him, nor were they counted faithful in his covenant. But he is merciful, and will forgive their sins, and will not destroy them. And many a time did he turn away his anger, and did not kindle all his wrath. And he remembered that they are flesh, a wind that goeth and returneth not. How often did they provoke him in the desert, and move him to wrath in the place without water? And they turned back and tempted God, and grieved the Holy One of Israel. They remembered not his hand, in the day that he redeemed them from the hand of him that afflicted them, how he wrought his signs in Egypt, and his wonders in the field of Tanis. And he turned their rivers into blood, and their showers that they might not drink. He sent amongst them divers sores of flies, which devoured them, and frogs which destroyed them. And he gave up their fruits to the blast, and their labors to the locust. And he destroyed their vineyards with hail, and their mulberry trees with hoar frost. And he gave up their cattle to the hail, and their stock to the fire. And he sent upon them the wrath of his indignation and wrath and trouble, which he sent by evil angels. He made a way for a path to his anger, he spared not their souls from death, and their cattle he shut up in death. And he killed all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, the firstfruits of all their labor in the tabernacles of Cham. And he took away his own people as sheep, and guided them in the wilderness like a flock. And he brought them out in hope, and they feared not, then the sea overwhelmed their enemies. And he brought them into the mountain of his sanctuary, the mountain which his right hand had purchased. And he cast out the Gentiles before them, and by lot divided to them their land by a line of distribution. And he made the tribes of Israel to dwell in their tabernacles. Yet they tempted, and provoked the Most High God, and they kept not his testimonies. And they turned away, and kept not the covenant, even like their fathers they were turned aside as a crooked bow. They provoked him to anger on their hills, and moved him to jealousy with their graven things. God heard, and despised them, and he reduced Israel exceedingly as it were to nothing. And he put away the tabernacle of Silo, his tabernacle where he dwelt among men. And he delivered their strength into captivity, and their beauty into the hands of the enemy. And he shut up his people under the sword, and he despised his inheritance. Fire consumed their young men, and their maidens were not lamented. Their priests fell by the sword, and their widows did not mourn. And the Lord was awaked as one out of sleep, and like a mighty man that hath been surfeited with wine. And he smote his enemies on the hinder parts, he put them to an everlasting reproach. And he rejected the tabernacle of Joseph, and chose not the tribe of Ephraim, but he chose the tribe of Judah, Mount Zion which he loved. And he built his sanctuary as of unicorns, in the land which he founded forever. And he chose his servant David, and took him from the flocks of sheep, he brought him from following the ewes great with young. As of unicorns, that is, firm and strong like the horn of the unicorn. This is one of the chiefest of the propositions of this psalm, foreshewing the firm establishment of the one, true, and everlasting sanctuary of God, in his church. To feed Jacob his servant, and Israel his inheritance. And he fed them in the innocence of his heart, and conducted them by the skillfulness of his hands. Deus, venerunt gentes. The church in time of persecution breath for relief. It seems to belong to the time of the Maccabees. A psalm for Asaph. O God, the heathens are come into thy inheritance, they have defiled thy holy temple, they have made Jerusalem as a place to keep fruit. They have given the dead bodies of thy servants to be meat for the fowls of the air, the flesh of thy saints for the beasts of the earth. They have poured out their blood as water, round about Jerusalem, and there was none to bury them. We are become a reproach to our neighbors, a scorn and derision to them that are round about us. How long, O Lord, wilt thou be angry forever? Shall thy zeal be kindled like a fire? Pour out thy wrath upon the nations that have not known thee, and upon the kingdoms that have not called upon thy name. Because they have devoured Jacob, and have laid waste his place. Remember not our former iniquities, let thy mercies speedily prevent us, for we are become exceeding poor. Help us, O God, our Savior, and for the glory of thy name, O Lord, deliver us, and forgive us our sins for thy name's sake, lest they should say among the Gentiles, where is their God? And let him be made known among the nations before our eyes, by the revenge in the blood of thy servants, which hath been shed. Let the sighing of the prisoners come in before thee. According to the greatness of thy arm, take possession of the children of them that have been put to death. And render to our neighbor sevenfold in their bosom, the reproach wherewith they have reproached thee, O Lord. But we thy people, and the sheep of thy pasture, will give thanks to thee forever. We will show forth thy praise, unto generation and generation. Qui regis Israel. A prayer for the church in tribulation, commemorating God's former favors. Unto the end, for them that shall he changed, a testimony for Asaph, a psalm. Give ear, O thou that rulest Israel, thou that leadest Joseph like a sheep. Thou that sittest upon the cherubims, shine forth before Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasses. Stir up thy might, and come to save us. Convert us, O God, and show us thy face, and we shall be saved. O Lord God of hosts, how long wilt thou be angry against the prayer of thy servant? How long wilt thou feed us with the bread of tears, and give us for our drink tears in measure? Thou hast made us to be a contradiction to our neighbors, and our enemies have scoffed at us. O God of hosts, convert us, and show thy face, and we shall be saved. Thou hast brought a vineyard out of Egypt, thou hast cast cut the Gentiles and planted it. Thou wast the guide of its journey in its sight, thou plantedst the roots thereof, and it filled the land. The shadow of it covered the hills, and the branches thereof the cedars of God. It stretched forth its branches unto the sea, and its boughs unto the river. Why hast thou broken down the hedge thereof, so that all they who pass by the way do pluck it? The boar out of the wood hath laid it waste, and a singular wild beast hath devoured it. Turn again, O God of hosts, look down from heaven, and see, and visit this vineyard. And perfect the same which thy right hand hath planted, and upon the Son of Man whom thou hast confirmed for thyself. Things set on fire and dug down shall perish at the rebuke of thy countenance. Let thy hand be upon the man of thy right hand, and upon the Son of Man whom thou hast confirmed for thyself. And we depart not from thee, thou shalt quicken us, and we will call upon thy name. O Lord God of hosts, convert us, and show thy face, and we shall be saved. Things set on fire, so this vineyard of thine, almost consumed already, must perish, if thou continue thy rebukes. The man of thy right hand, Christ. Exalted Deo. An invitation to a solemn praising of God. Unto the end, for the wine presses, a psalm for Asaph himself. Rejoice to God our helper, sing aloud to the God of Jacob. Take a psalm, and bring hither the timbrel, the pleasant psaltery with the harp. Blow up the trumpet on the new moon, on the noted day of your solemnity. For it is a commandment in Israel, and a judgment to the God of Jacob. For the wine presses, Dorcularibus. It either signifies a musical instrument, or that this psalm was to be sung at the Feast of the Tabernacles after the gathering in of the vintage. He ordained it for a testimony in Joseph, when he came out of the land of Egypt, he heard a tongue which he knew not. He removed his back from the burdens, his hands had served in baskets. Thou calledst upon me in affliction, and I delivered thee, I heard thee in the secret place of tempest, I proved thee at the waters of contradiction. Hear, O my people, and I will testify to thee, O Israel, if thou wilt hearken to me, there shall be no new God in thee, neither shalt thou adore a strange God. In the secret place of tempest, Heb, of thunder. When thou soughtest to hide thyself from the tempest, or, when I came down to Mount Sinai, hidden from thy eyes in a storm of thunder. For I am the Lord thy God, who brought thee out of the land of Egypt, open thy mouth wide, and I will fill it. But my people heard not my voice, and Israel hearkened not to me. So I let them go according to the desires of their heart, they shall walk in their own inventions. If my people had heard me, if Israel had walked in my ways, I should soon have humbled their enemies, and laid my hand on them that troubled them. The enemies of the Lord have lied to him, and their time shall be forever. And he fed them with the fat of wheat, and filled them with honey out of the rock. Their time shall be forever, impenitent sinners shall suffer forever. Deus sted. An exhortation to judges and men in power. A psalm for Asaph. God hath stood in the congregation of gods, and being in the midst of them he judgeth gods. How long will you judge unjustly, and accept the persons of the wicked? Judge for the needy and fatherless, do justice to the humble and the poor. Rescue the poor, and deliver the needy out of the hand of the sinner. They have not known nor understood, they walk on in darkness, all the foundations of the earth shall be moved. I have said, you are gods and all of you the sons of the Most High. But you like men shall die, and shall fall like one of the princes. Arise, O God, judge thou the earth, for thou shalt inherit among all the nations. Deus, quis similes. A prayer against the enemies of God's church. A canticle of a psalm for Asaph. O God, who shall be like to thee? Hold not thy peace, neither be thou still, O God. For lo, thy enemies have made a noise, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They have taken a malicious counsel against thy people, and have consulted against thy saints. They have said, Come and let us destroy them, so that they be not a nation, and let the name of Israel be remembered no more. For they have contrived with one consent, they have made a covenant together against thee, the tabernacles of the Edomites, and the Ismaelites, Moab, and the Agarans, Jebel, and Ammon and Amalek, the Philistines, with the inhabitants of Tyre. Yea, and the Assyrian also is joined with them, they are come to the aid of the sons of Lot. Do to them as thou didst to Midian and to Sisara, as to Jabin at the brook of Sison, who perished at Ender, and became as dung for the earth. Make their princes like Horeb, and Zeb, and Zebi, and Salmana. All their princes, who have said, Let us possess the sanctuary of God for an inheritance. O my God, make them like a wheel, and as stubble before the wind, as fire which burnt the wood, and as a flame burning mountains. So shalt thou pursue them with thy tempest, and shalt trouble them in thy wrath. Fill their faces with shame, and they shall seek thy name, O Lord. Let them be ashamed and troubled for ever and ever, and let them be confounded and perish. And let them know that the Lord is thy name, thou alone art the Most High over all of the earth. Quam lecta. The soul aspireth after heaven, rejoicing in the meantime, in being in the communion of God's church upon earth. Unto the end, for the wine presses, a psalm for the sons of Kor. How lovely are thy tabernacles, O Lord of hosts! My soul longeth and fainteth for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh have rejoiced in the living God. For the sparrow hath found herself a house, and the turtle a nest for herself where she may lay her young ones, thy altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Blessed are they that dwell in thy house, O Lord, they shall praise thee for ever and ever. Blessed is the man whose help is from thee, in his heart he hath disposed to ascend by steps, in the vale of tears, in the place which he hath set. For the lawgiver shall give a blessing, they shall go from virtue to virtue, the God of God shall be seen in Sion. O Lord God of hosts, hear my prayer, give ear, O God of Jacob. Behold, O God our protector, and look on the face of thy Christ. In his heart he hath disposed to ascend by steps, ascension is in cords uo disposuit. As by steps men ascended to the temple of God situated on a hill, so the good Christian ascends towards the eternal temple by certain steps of virtue disposed or ordered within the heart, and this whilst he lives as yet in the body, in this vale of tears, the place which man hath set, that is, which he hath brought himself to, being cast out of paradise for his sin. For better is one day in thy courts above thousands. I have chosen to be an abject in the house of my God, rather than to dwell in the tabernacles of sinners. For God loveth mercy and truth, the Lord will give grace and glory. He will not deprive of good things them that walk in innocence, O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusteth in thee. Benedixisti, Domini. The coming of Christ, to bring peace and salvation to man. Unto the end, for the sons of Kor, a psalm. Lord, thou hast blessed thy land, thou hast turned away the captivity of Jacob. Thou hast forgiven the iniquity of thy people, thou hast covered all their sins. Thou hast mitigated all thy anger, thou hast turned away from the wrath of thy indignation. Convert us, O God our Savior, and turn off thy anger from us. Wilt thou be angry with us forever, or wilt thou extend thy wrath from generation to generation? Thou wilt turn, O God, and bring us to life, and thy people shall rejoice in thee. Show us, O Lord, thy mercy, and grant us thy salvation. I will hear what the Lord God will speak in me, for he will speak peace unto his people, and unto his saints, and unto them that are converted to the heart. Surely his salvation is near to them that fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth have met each other, justice and peace have kissed. Truth is sprung out of the earth, and justice hath looked down from heaven. For the Lord will give goodness, and our earth shall yield her fruit. Justice shall walk before him, and shall set his steps in the way. Inclina, Domini. A prayer for God's grace to assist us to the end. A prayer for David himself. Incline thy ear, O Lord, and hear me, for I am needy and poor. Preserve my soul, for I am holy, save thy servant, O my God, that trusteth in thee. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I have cried to thee all the day. Give joy to the soul of thy servant, for to thee, O Lord, I have lifted up my soul. For thou, O Lord, art sweet and mild, and plenteous in mercy to all that call upon thee. I am holy, I am by my office and profession dedicated to thy service. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer, and attend to the voice of my petition. I have called upon thee in the day of my trouble, because thou hast heard me. There is none among the gods like unto thee, O Lord, and there is none according to thy works. All the nations thou hast made shall come and adore before thee, O Lord, and they shall glorify thy name. For thou art great and dost wonderful things, thou art God alone. Conduct me, O Lord, in thy way, and I will walk in thy truth, let my heart rejoice that it may fear thy name. I will praise thee, O Lord my God, with my whole heart, and I will glorify thy name forever, for thy mercy is great towards me, and thou hast delivered my soul out of the lower hell. O God, the wicked are risen up against me, and the assembly of the mighty have sought my soul, and they have not set thee before their eyes. And thou, O Lord, art a God of compassion, and merciful, patient, and of much mercy, and true. O look upon me, and have mercy on me, give thy command to thy servant, and save the son of thy handmaid. Show me a token for good, that they who hate me may see, and be confounded, because thou, O Lord, hast helped me and hast comforted me. Fundamenta Jus. The glory of the Church of Christ. For the sons of Kor, a psalm of a canticle. The foundations thereof are in the holy mountains, the Lord loveth the gates of Sion above all the tabernacles of Jacob. Glorious things are said of thee, O city of God. I will be mindful of Rahab and of Babylon knowing me. Behold the foreigners, and Tyre, and the people of the Ethiopians, these were there. Shall not Sion say, this man and that man is born in her? And the Highest himself hath founded her. The holy mountains, the apostles and prophets. Ephesians 2 verse 20. Rahab, Egypt, etc. To this Sion, which is the Church of God, many shall resort from all nations. Shall not Sion say, the meaning is, that Sion, viz., the Church, shall not only be able to commemorate this or that particular person of renown born in her, but also to glory in great multitudes of people and princes of her communion, who have been foretold in the writings of the prophets, and registered in the writings of the apostles. The Lord shall tell in his writings of peoples and of princes, of them that have been in her. The dwelling in thee is as it were of all rejoicing. Domini, Deus Solitus. A prayer of one under grievous affliction, it agrees to Christ in his passion, and alludes to his death and burial. A canticle of a psalm for the sons of Kor, unto the end, for Maleth, to answer understanding of them and the Israelite. O Lord, the God of my salvation, I have cried in the day, and in the night before thee. Let my prayer come in before thee, incline thy ear to my petition. For my soul is filled with evils, and my life hath drawn nigh to hell. I am counted among them that go down to the pit, I am become as a man without help. Maleth, a musical instrument, or chorus of musicians, to answer one another. Ibid. Understanding, or a psalm of instruction, composed by Amon the Israelite, or by David, in his name. Free among the dead. Like the slain sleeping in the sepulchres, whom thou rememberest no more, and they are cast off from thy hand. They have laid me in the lower pit, in the dark places, and in the shadow of death. Thy wrath is strong over me, and all thy waves thou hast brought in upon me. Thou hast put away my acquaintance far from me, they have set me an abomination to themselves. I was delivered up, and came not forth, my eyes languished through poverty. All the day I cried to thee, O Lord, I stretched out my hands to thee. Wilt thou show wonders to the dead? Or shall physicians raise to life, and give praise to thee? Shall anyone in the sepulchre declare thy mercy, and thy truth in destruction? Shall thy wonders be known in the dark, and thy justice in the land of forgetfulness? But I, O Lord, have cried to thee, and in the morning my prayer shall prevent thee. Lord, why castest thou off my prayer, why turnest thou away thy face from me? I am poor, and in labors from my youth, and being exalted have been humbled and troubled. Thy wrath hath come upon me, and thy terrors have troubled me. They have come round about me like water all the day, they have compassed me about together. Friend and neighbor thou hast put far from me, and my acquaintance, because of misery. Misericordias Domini. The perpetuity of the Church of Christ, in consequence of the promise of God, which, notwithstanding, God permits her to suffer sometimes most grievous afflictions. Of understanding, for Ethan the Israelite. The mercies of the Lord I will sing forever. I will show forth thy truth with my mouth to generation and generation. For thou hast said, mercy shall be built up forever in the heavens, thy truth shall be prepared in them. I have made a covenant with my elect, I have sworn to David my servant, thy seed will I settle forever. And I will build up thy throne unto generation and generation. The heavens shall confess thy wonders, O Lord, and thy truth in the church of the saints. For who in the clouds can be compared to the Lord, or who among the sons of God shall be like to God? God, who is glorified in the assembly of the saints, great and terrible above all them that are about him. O Lord God of hosts, who is like to thee? Thou art mighty, O Lord, and thy truth is round about thee. Thou rulest the power of the sea, and appeasest the motion of the waves thereof. Thou hast humbled the proud one, as one that is slain, with the arm of thy strength thou hast scattered thy enemies. Thine are the heavens, and thine is the earth, the world and the fullness thereof thou hast founded, the north and the sea thou hast created. Thabor and Hermon shall rejoice in thy name, thy arm is with might. Let thy hand be strengthened, and thy right hand exalted, justice and judgment are the preparation of thy throne. Mercy and truth shall go before thy face. Blessed is the people that knoweth jubilation. They shall walk, O Lord, in the light of thy countenance, and in thy name they shall rejoice all the day, and in thy justice they shall be exalted. For thou art the glory of their strength, and in thy good pleasure shall our horn be exalted. For our protection is of the Lord, and of our King the Holy One of Israel. Then thou spokest in a vision to thy saints, and saidst, I have laid help upon one that is mighty, and have exalted one chosen out of my people. I have found David my servant, with my holy oil I have anointed him. For my hand shall help him, and my arm shall strengthen him. The enemy shall have no advantage over him, nor the sons of iniquity have power to hurt him. And I will cut down his enemies before his face, and them that hate him I will put to flight. And my truth and my mercy shall be with him, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. And I will set his hand in the sea, and his right hand in the rivers. He shall cry out to me, Thou art my Father, my God, and the support of my salvation. And I will make him my firstborn, high above the kings of the earth. I will keep my mercy for him forever, and my covenant faithful to him. And I will make his seed to endure forevermore, and his throne as the days of heaven. And if his children forsake my law, and walk not in my judgments, if they profane my justices, and keep not my commandments, I will visit their iniquities with a rod, and their sins with stripes. But my mercy I will not take away from him, nor will I suffer my truth to fail. Neither will I profane my covenant, and the words that proceed from my mouth I will not make void. Once have I sworn by my holiness, I will not lie unto David, his seed shall endure forever. And his throne as the sun before me, and as the moon perfect forever, and a faithful witness in heaven. But thou hast rejected and despised, thou hast been angry with thy anointed. Thou hast overthrown the covenant of thy servant, thou hast profaned his sanctuary on the earth. Overthrown the covenant, all this seems to relate to the time of the captivity of Babylon, in which, for the sins of the people and their princes, God seemed to have set aside for a while the covenant he made with David. Thou hast broken down all his hedges, thou hast made his strength fear. All that pass by the way have robbed him, he is become a reproach to his neighbors. Thou hast set up the right hand of them that oppress him, thou hast made all his enemies to rejoice. Thou hast turned away the help of his sword, and hast not assisted him in battle. Thou hast made his purification to cease, and thou hast cast his throne down to the ground. Thou hast shortened the days of his time, thou hast covered him with confusion. How long, O Lord, turnest thou away unto the end? Shall thy anger burn like fire? Remember what my substance is, for hast thou made all the children of men in vain? Who is the man that shall live, and not see death, that shall deliver his soul from the hand of hell? Lord, where are thy ancient mercies, according to what thou didst swear to David in thy truth? Be mindful, O Lord, of the reproach of thy servants, which I have held in my bosom, of many nations, wherewith thy enemies have reproached, O Lord, wherewith they have reproached the change of thy anointed. Blessed be the Lord forevermore. So be it. So be it. Domini, Refugium. A prayer for the mercy of God, recounting the shortness and miseries of the days of man. A prayer of Moses the man of God. Lord, thou hast been our refuge from generation to generation. Before the mountains were made, or the earth and the world was formed, from eternity into eternity thou art God. Turn not man away to be brought low, and thou hast said, Be converted, O ye sons of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are as yesterday, which is past. And as a watch in the night, things that are counted nothing, shall their years be. Turn not man away, suffer him not quite to perish from thee, since thou art pleased to call upon him to be converted to thee. In the morning man shall grow up like grass, in the morning he shall flourish and pass away, in the evening he shall fall, grow dry, and wither. For in thy wrath we have fainted away, and are troubled in thy indignation. Thou hast set our iniquities before thy eyes, our life in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are spent, and in thy wrath we have fainted away. Our years shall be considered as a spider, the days of our years in them are 70 years. But if in the strong they be 80 years, and what is more of them is labor and sorrow. For mildness is come upon us, and we shall be corrected. As a spider, as frail and weak as a spider's web, and miserable withal, whilst like a spider we spend our bowels in weaving webs to catch flies. Mildness is come upon us, God's mildness corrects us, inasmuch as he deals kindly with us, in shortening the days of this miserable life, and so weaning our affections from all its transitory enjoyments, and teaching us true wisdom. Who knoweth the power of thy anger, and for thy fear can number thy wrath? So make thy right hand known, and men learned in heart, in wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? And be entreated in favor of thy servants. We are filled in the morning with thy mercy, and we have rejoiced, and are delighted all our days. We have rejoiced for the days in which thou hast humbled us, for the years in which we have seen evils. Look upon thy servants and upon their works, and direct their children. And let the brightness of the Lord our God be upon us, and direct thou the works of our hands over us, yea, the work of our hands do thou direct. Gehabitat. The just is secure under the protection of God. The praise of a canticle for David. He that dwelleth in the aid of the Most High, shall abide under the protection of the God of Jacob. He shall say to the Lord, Thou art my protector, and my refuge, my God, in him will I trust. For he hath delivered me from the snare of the hunters, and from the sharp word. He will overshadow thee with his shoulders, and under his wings thou shalt trust. His truth shall compass thee with a shield, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror of the night. Of the arrow that fleeth in the day, of the business that walketh about in the dark, of invasion, or of the noonday devil. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. But thou shalt consider with thy eyes, and shalt see the reward of the wicked. Because thou, O Lord, art my hope, thou hast made the Most High thy refuge. There shall no evil come to thee, nor shall the scourge come near thy dwelling. For he hath given his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. In their hands they shall bear thee up, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt walk upon the asp and the basilisk, and thou shalt trample underfoot the lion and the dragon. Because he hoped in me, I will deliver him, I will protect him because he hath known my name. He shall cry to me, and I will hear him, I am with him in tribulation, I will deliver him, and I will glorify him. I will fill him with length of days, and I will show him my salvation. Bonum est et confiteri. God is to be praised for his wondrous works. A psalm of a canticle on the Sabbath day. It is good to give praise to the Lord, and to sing to thy name, O Most High. To show forth thy mercy in the morning, and thy truth in the night, upon an instrument of 10 strings, upon the psaltery, with a canticle upon the harp. For thou hast given me, O Lord, a delight in thy doings, and in the works of thy hands I shall rejoice. O Lord, how great are thy works! Thy thoughts are exceeding deep. The senseless man shall not know, nor will the fool understand these things. When the wicked shall spring up as grass, and all the workers of iniquity shall appear, that they may perish for ever and ever, but thou, O Lord, art most high for evermore. For behold thy enemies, O Lord, for behold thy enemies shall perish, and all the workers of iniquity shall be scattered. But my horn shall be exalted like that of the unicorn, and my old age in plentiful mercy. My eye also hath looked down upon my enemies, and my ear shall hear of the downfall of the malignant that rise up against me. The just shall flourish like the palm tree, he shall grow up like the cedar of Libanus. They that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of the house of our God. They shall still increase in a fruitful old age, and shall be well treated. That they may show, that the Lord our God is righteous, and there is no iniquity in him. Dominus regnavit. The glory and stability of the kingdom, that is, of the Church of Christ. Praise in the way of a canticle, for David himself, on the day before the Sabbath, when the earth was founded. The Lord hath reigned, he is clothed with beauty, the Lord is clothed with strength, and hath girded himself. For he hath established the world which shall not be moved. Thy throne is prepared from of old, thou art from everlasting. The floods have lifted up, O Lord, the floods have lifted up their voice. The floods have lifted up their waves, with the noise of many waters. Wonderful are the surges of the sea, wonderful is the Lord on high. Thy testimonies are become exceedingly credible, holiness becometh thy house, O Lord, unto length of days. Deus ultionum. God shall judge and punish the oppressors of his people. A psalm for David himself on the fourth day of the week. The Lord is the God to whom revenge belongeth, the God of revenge hath acted freely. Lift up thyself, thou that judgest the earth, render a reward to the proud. How long shall sinners, O Lord, how long shall sinners glory? Shall they utter, and speak iniquity, shall all speak who work injustice? Thy people, O Lord, they have brought low, and they have afflicted thy inheritance. They have slain the widow and the stranger, and they have murdered the fatherless. And they have said, the Lord shall not see, neither shall the God of Jacob understand. Understand, ye senseless among the people, and, you fools, be wise at last. He that planted the ear, shall he not hear? Or he that formed the eye, doth he not consider? He that chastiseth nations, shall he not rebuke, he that teacheth man knowledge? The Lord knoweth the thoughts of men, that they are vain. Blessed is the man whom thou shalt instruct, O Lord, and shalt teach him out of thy law. That thou mayst give him rest from the evil days, till a pit be dug for the wicked. For the Lord will not cast off his people, neither will he forsake his own inheritance. Until justice be turned into judgment, and they that are near it are all the upright in heart. Rest from the evil days, that thou mayst mitigate the sorrows, to which he is exposed, during the short and evil days of his mortality. Until justice be turned into judgment, by being put in execution, which will be agreeable to all the upright in heart. Who shall rise up for me against the evildoers? Or who shall stand with me against the workers of iniquity? Unless the Lord had been my helper, my soul had almost dwelt in hell. If I said, my foot is moved, thy mercy, O Lord, assisted me. According to the multitude of my sorrows in my heart, thy comforts have given joy to my soul. Doth the seat of iniquity stick to thee, to framest labor in commandment? Doth the seat of iniquity stick to thee, that is, wilt thou, O God, who art always just, admit of the seat of iniquity, that is, of injustice, or unjust judges, to have any partnership with thee? Thou who framest, or makest, labor in commandment, that is, thou who obligest us to labor with all diligence to keep thy commandments. They will hunt after the soul of the just, and will condemn innocent blood. But the Lord is my refuge, and my God the help of my hope. And he will render them their iniquity, and in their malice he will destroy them, the Lord our God will destroy them. Venit exultemus. An invitation to adore and serve God, and to hear his voice. Praise of a canticle for David himself. Come, let us praise the Lord with joy, let us joyfully sing to God our Savior. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and make a joyful noise to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. For in his hand are all the ends of the earth, and the heights of the mountains are his. For the sea is his, and he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Come, let us adore and fall down, and weep before the Lord that made us. For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Today if you shall hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, according to the day of temptation in the wilderness, where your fathers tempted me, they proved me, and saw my works. 40 years long was I offended with that generation, and I said, these always err in heart. And these men have not known my ways, so I swore in my wrath that they shall not enter into my rest. Cantate Domino. An exhortation to praise God for the coming of Christ and his kingdom. A canticle for David himself, when the house was built after the captivity. Sing ye to the Lord a new canticle, sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing ye to the Lord and bless his name, show forth his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the Gentiles, his wonders among all people. For the Lord is great, and exceedingly to be praised, he is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the Gentiles are devils, but the Lord made the heavens. When the house was built, alluding to that time, and then ordered to be sung, but principally relating to the building of the Church of Christ, after our redemption from the captivity of Satan. Praise and beauty are before him, holiness and majesty in his sanctuary. Bring ye to the Lord, O ye kindreds of the Gentiles, bring ye to the Lord glory and honor, bring to the Lord glory unto his name. Bring up sacrifices, and come into his courts, adore ye the Lord in his holy court. Let all the earth be moved at his presence. Say ye among the Gentiles, the Lord hath reigned. For he hath corrected the world, which shall not be moved, he will judge the people with justice. Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad, let the sea be moved, and the fullness thereof, the fields and all things that are in them shall be joyful. Then shall all the trees of the woods rejoice before the face of the Lord, because he cometh to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with justice, and the people with his truth. Dominus regnavit. All are invited to rejoice at the glorious coming and reign of Christ. For the same David, when his land was restored again to him. The Lord hath reigned, let the earth rejoice, let many islands be glad. Clouds and darkness are round about him, justice and judgment are the establishment of his throne. A fire shall go before him, and shall burn his enemies round about. His lightnings have shone forth to the world, the earth saw and trembled. The mountains melted like wax, at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the Lord of all of the earth. Clouds and darkness, the coming of Christ in the clouds with great terror and majesty to judge the world, is here prophesied. The heavens declared his justice, and all people saw his glory. Let them be all confounded that adore graven things, and that glory in their idols. Adore him, all you his angels, Sion heard, and was glad. And the daughters of Judah rejoiced, because of thy judgments, O Lord. For thou art the Most High Lord over all the earth, thou art exalted exceedingly above all gods. You that love the Lord, hate evil, the Lord preserveth the souls of his saints, He will deliver them out of the hand of the sinner. Light is risen to the just, and joy to the right of heart. Rejoice, ye just, in the Lord, and give praise to the remembrance of His holiness. Cantate Domino. All are again invited to praise the Lord, for the victories of Christ. A psalm for David himself. Sing ye to the Lord a new canticle, because He hath done wonderful things. His right hand hath wrought for Him salvation, and His arm is holy. The Lord hath made known His salvation, He hath revealed His justice in the sight of the Gentiles. He hath remembered His mercy, His truth toward the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Sing joyfully to God, all the earth, make melody, rejoice and sing. Sing praise to the Lord on the harp, and with the voice of a psalm. With long trumpets, and sound of comet. Make a joyful noise before the Lord our King, let the sea be moved and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. The rivers shall clap their hands, the mountains shall rejoice together at the presence of the Lord, because He cometh to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with justice, and the people with equity. Dominus regnavit. The reign of the Lord in Sion, that is, of Christ and His church. A psalm for David himself. The Lord hath reigned, let the people be angry, he that sitteth on the cherubims, let the earth be moved. The Lord is great in Sion, and high above all people, let them give praise to thy great name, for it is terrible and holy, and the king's honor loveth judgment. Thou hast prepared directions, thou hast done judgment and justice in Jacob. Exalt ye the Lord our God, and adore His footstool, for it is holy. Let the people be angry, though many enemies rage, and the whole earth be stirred up to oppose the reign of Christ, He shall still prevail. Loveth judgment, requireth discretion. Abid. Directions, most right and just laws to direct men. Adore His footstool, the Ark of the Covenant was called, in the Old Testament, God's footstool, over which He was understood to sit, on His propitiatory, or mercy seat, as on a throne, between the wings of the cherubims, in the sanctuary, to which the children of Israel paid a great veneration. But as this psalm evidently relates to Christ, and the New Testament, where the Ark has no place, the Holy Fathers understand this text, of the worship paid by the Church to the body and blood of Christ in the sacred mysteries, inasmuch as the humanity of Christ is, as it were, the footstool of the divinity. So St. Ambrose, L. De Spiritu Sancto, C. and St. Augustine upon this psalm. Moses and Aaron among his priests, and Samuel among them that call upon His name. They called upon the Lord, and He heard them, He spoke to them in the pillar of the cloud. They kept His testimonies, and the commandment which He gave them. Thou didst hear them, O Lord our God, Thou wast a merciful God to them, and taking vengeance on all their inventions. Exalt ye the Lord our God, and adore at His holy mountain, for the Lord our God is holy. Moses and Aaron among His priests. By this it is evident, that Moses also was a priest, and indeed the chief priest, inasmuch as he consecrated Aaron, and offered sacrifice for him. Lev. So that his preeminence over Aaron makes nothing for lay church headship. All their inventions, that is, all the enterprises of their enemies against them, as in the case of Kor, Dathan, and Abiram. Jubilate Deo. All are invited to rejoice in God the Creator of all. A psalm of praise. Sing joyfully to God, all the earth, serve ye the Lord with gladness. Come in before His presence with exceeding great joy. Know ye that the Lord He is God, He made us, and not we ourselves. We are His people and the sheep of His pasture. Go ye into His gates with praise, into His courts with hymns, and give glory to Him. Praise ye His name, for the Lord is sweet, His mercy endureth forever, and His truth to generation and generation. Misericordiam et judicium. The prophet exhorteth all by his example, to follow mercy and justice. A psalm for David himself. Mercy and judgment I will sing to Thee, O Lord, I will sing, and I will understand in the unspotted way, when Thou shalt come to me. I walked in the innocence of my heart, in the midst of my house. I did not set before my eyes any unjust thing, I hated the workers of iniquities. The perverse heart did not cleave to me, and the malignant, that turned aside from me, I would not know. The man that in private detracted his neighbor, him did I persecute. With him that had a proud eye, and an insatiable heart, I would not eat. I will understand, that is, I will apply my mind, I will do my endeavor, to know and to follow the perfect way of thy commandments, not trusting to my own strength, but relying on thy coming to me by thy grace. My eyes were upon the faithful of the earth, to sit with me, the man that walked in the perfect way, he served me. He that worketh pride shall not dwell in the midst of my house, he that speaketh unjust things did not prosper before my eyes. In the morning I put to death all the wicked of the land, that I might cut off all the workers of iniquity from the city of the Lord. Domini, exaudi. A prayer for one in affliction, the fifth penitential psalm. The prayer of the poor man, when he was anxious, and poured out his supplication before the Lord. Hear, O Lord, my prayer, and let my cry come to thee. Turn not away thy face from me, in the day when I am in trouble, incline thy ear to me. In what day soever I shall call upon thee, hear me speedily. For my days are vanished like smoke, and my bones are grown dry like fuel for the fire. I am smitten as grass, and my heart is withered, because I forgot to eat my bread. Through the voice of my groaning, my bone hath cleaved to my flesh. I am become like to a pelican of the wilderness, I am like a night raven in the house. I have watched, and am become as a sparrow all alone on the housetop. All the day long my enemies reproached me, and they that praised me did swear against me. For I did eat ashes like bread, and mingled my drink with weeping. A pelican, I am become through grief, like birds that affect solitude and darkness. Because of thy anger and indignation, for having lifted me up thou hast thrown me down. My days have declined like a shadow, and I am withered like grass. But thou, O Lord, endurest forever, and thy memorial to all generations. Thou shalt arise and have mercy on Sion, for it is time to have mercy on it, for the time is come. For the stones thereof have pleased thy servants, and they shall have pity on the earth thereof. And the Gentiles shall fear thy name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth thy glory. For the Lord hath built up Sion, and he shall be seen in his glory. He hath had regard to the prayer of the humble, and he hath not despised their petition. Let these things be written unto another generation, and the people that shall be created shall praise the Lord, because he hath looked forth from his high sanctuary, from heaven the Lord hath looked upon the earth. That he might hear the groans of them that are in fetters, that he might release the children of the slain, that they may declare the name of the Lord in Sion, and his praise in Jerusalem, when the people assemble together, and kings, to serve the Lord. He answered him in the way of his strength, declare unto me the fewness of my days. Call me not away in the midst of my days, thy years are unto generation and generation. He answered him in the way of his strength, that is, the people, mentioned in the foregoing verse, or the penitent, in whose person this psalm is delivered, answered the Lord in the way of his strength, that is, according to the best of his power and strength, or when he was in the flower of his age and strength, inquiring after the fewness of his days, to know if he should live long enough to see the happy restoration of Sion, etc. In the beginning, O Lord, thou foundedst the earth, and the heavens are the works of thy hands. They shall perish but thou remainest, and all of them shall grow old like a garment, and as a vesture thou shalt change them, and they shall be changed. But thou art always the selfsame, and thy years shall not fail. The children of thy servants shall continue, and their seed shall be directed forever. Benedict, Anima. Thanksgiving to God for his mercies. For David himself. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and let all that is within me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and never forget all he hath done for thee. Who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who satisfieth thy desire with good things, thy youth shall be renewed like the eagle's. The Lord doth mercies, and judgment for all that suffer wrong. He hath made his ways known to Moses, his wills to the children of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, long-suffering and plenteous in mercy. He will not always be angry, nor will he threaten forever. He hath not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For according to the height of the heaven above the earth, he hath strengthened his mercy towards them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. As a father hath compassion on his children, so hath the Lord compassion on them that fear him, for he knoweth our frame. He remembereth that we are dust, man's days are as grass, as the flower of the field so shall he flourish. For the Spirit shall pass in him, and he shall not be, and he shall know his place no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity and unto eternity upon them that fear him, and his justice unto children's children, to such as keep his covenant, and are mindful of his commandments to do them. The Lord hath prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom shall rule over all. Bless the Lord, all ye his angels, you that are mighty in strength, and execute his word, hearkening to the voice of his orders. Bless the Lord, all ye his hosts, you ministers of his that do his will. Bless the Lord, all his works, in every place of his dominion, O my soul, bless thou the Lord. Benedict, Anima. God is to be praised for his mighty works, and wonderful providence. For David himself. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O Lord my God, thou art exceedingly great. Thou hast put on praise and beauty, and art clothed with light as with a garment. Who stretchest out the heaven like a pavilion, who coverest the higher rooms thereof with water. Who makest the clouds thy chariot, who walkest upon the wings of the winds. Who makest thy angels spirits, and thy ministers a burning fire. Who hast founded the earth upon its own basis, it shall not be moved for ever and ever. The deep like a garment is its clothing, above the mountains shall the waters stand. At thy rebuke they shall flee, at the voice of thy thunder they shall fear. The mountains ascend, and the plains descend into the place which thou hast founded for them. Thou hast set a bound which they shall not pass over, neither shall they return to cover the earth. Thou sendest forth springs in the vales, between the midst of the hills the waters shall pass. All the beasts of the field shall drink, the wild asses shall expect in their thirst. Over them the birds of the air shall dwell, from the midst of the rocks they shall give forth their voices. Thou waterest the hills from thy upper rooms, the earth shall be filled with the fruit of thy works, bringing forth grass for cattle, and herb for the service of men. That thou mayst bring bread out of the earth, and that wine may cheer the heart of man. That he may make the face cheerful with oil, and that bread may strengthen man's heart. The trees of the field shall be filled, and the cedars of Lebanon which he hath planted, there the sparrows shall make their nests. The highest of them is the house of the heron. The high hills are a refuge for the harts, the rock for the urchins. He hath made the moon for seasons, the sun knoweth his going down. Thou hast appointed darkness, and it is night, and it shall all the beasts of the woods go about. The young lions roaring after their prey, and seeking their meat from God. The sun ariseth, and they are gathered together, and they shall lie down in their dens. Man shall go forth to his work, and to his labor until the evening. How great are thy works, O Lord! Thou hast made all things in wisdom, the earth is filled with thy riches. So is this great sea, which stretcheth wide its arms, there are creeping things without number, creatures little and great. There the ships shall go. This sea dragon which thou hast formed to play therein. All expect of thee that thou give them food in season. What thou givest to them they shall gather up, when thou openest thy hand, they shall all be filled with good. But if thou turnest away thy face, they shall be troubled, thou shalt take away their breath, and they shall fail, and shall return to their dust. Thou shalt send forth thy spirit, and they shall be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever, the Lord shall rejoice in his works. He looketh upon the earth, and maketh it tremble, he toucheth the mountains, and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live, I will sing praise to my God while I have my being. Let my speech be acceptable to him, but I will take delight in the Lord. Let sinners be consumed out of the earth, and the unjust, so that they be no more, O my soul, bless thou the Lord. Confitmini Domino. A thanksgiving to God for his benefits to his people Israel. Alleluia. Alleluia. give glory to the Lord, and call upon his name, declare his deeds among the Gentiles. Sing to him, yea, sing praises to him, relate all his wondrous works. Glory ye in his holy name, let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord. Seek ye the Lord, and be strengthened, seek his face evermore. Remember his marvelous works which he hath done, his wonders, and the judgments of his mouth. O ye seed of Abraham his servant, ye sons of Jacob his chosen. He is the Lord our God, his judgments are in all the earth. He hath remembered his covenant for ever, the word which he commanded to a thousand generations. Which he made to Abraham, and his oath to Isaac, and he appointed the same to Jacob for a law, and to Israel for an everlasting testament. Saying, to thee will I give the land of Canaan, the lot of your inheritance. When they were but a small number, yea very few, and sojourners therein, and they passed from nation to nation, and from one kingdom to another people. He suffered no man to hurt them, and he reproved kings for their sakes. Touch ye not my anointed, and do no evil to my prophets. And he called a famine upon the land, and he broke in pieces all the support of bread. He sent a man before them, Joseph, who was sold for a slave. They humbled his feet in fetters, the iron pierced his soul, until his word came. The word of the Lord inflamed him. The king sent, and he released him, the ruler of the people, and he set him at liberty. He made him master of his house, and ruler of all his possession. That he might instruct his princes as himself, and teach his ancients wisdom. And Israel went into Egypt, and Jacob was a sojourner in the land of Cham. And he increased his people exceedingly, and strengthened them over their enemies, he turned their heart to hate his people, and to deal deceitfully with his servants. He turned their heart, not that God, who is never the author of sin, moved the Egyptians to hate and persecute his people, but that the Egyptians took occasion of hating and envying them, from the sight of the benefits which God bestowed upon them. He sent Moses his servant, Aaron the man whom he had chosen. He gave them power to show his signs, and his wonders in the land of Cham. He sent darkness, and made it obscure, and grieved not his words. He turned their waters into blood, and destroyed their fish. Their land brought forth frogs, in the inner chambers of their kings. Grieved not his words, that is, he was not wanting to fulfill his words, or he did not grieve Moses and Aaron, the carriers of his words, or he did not grieve his words, that is, his sons, the children of Israel, who enjoyed light whilst the Egyptians were oppressed with darkness. He spoke, and there came divers sorts of flies and synths in all their coasts. He gave them hail for rain, a burning fire in the land. And he destroyed their vineyards and their fig trees, and he broke in pieces the trees of their coasts. He spoke, and the locust came, and the brutus, of which there was no number. And they devoured all the grass in their land, and consumed all the fruit of their ground. Synephs, see the annotation, X. Brutus, an insect of the locust kind. And he slew all the firstborn in their land, the firstfruits of all their labor. And he brought them out with silver and gold, and there was not among their tribes one that was feeble. Egypt was glad when they departed, for the fear of them lay upon them. He spread a cloud for their protection, and fire to give them light in the night. They asked, and the quail came, and he filled them with the bread of heaven. He opened the rock, and waters flowed, rivers ran down in the dry land. Because he remembered his holy word, which he had spoken to his servant Abraham. And he brought forth his people with joy, and his chosen with gladness. And he gave them the lands of the Gentiles, and they possessed the labors of the people, that they might observe his justifications, and seek after his law. His justifications, that is, his commandments, which here, and in many other places of the Scripture, are called justifications, because the keeping of them makes man just. The Protestants render it by the word statutes, in favor of their doctrine, which does not allow good works to justify. Confitmini Domino. A confession of the manifold sins and ingratitudes of the Israelites. Alleluia. Alleluia. Give glory to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Who shall declare the powers of the Lord? Who shall set forth all his praises? Blessed are they that keep judgment, and do justice at all times. Remember us, O Lord, in the favor of thy people, visit us with thy salvation. That we may see the good of thy chosen, that we may rejoice in the joy of thy nation, that thou mayst be praised with thy inheritance. We have sinned with our fathers, we have acted unjustly, we have wrought iniquity. Our fathers understood not thy wonders in Egypt, they remembered not the multitude of thy mercies, and they provoked to wrath going up to the sea, even the Red Sea. And he saved them for his own name's sake, that he might make his power known. And he rebuked the Red Sea, and it was dried up, and he led them through the depths, as in a wilderness. And he saved them from the hand of them that hated them, and he redeemed them from the hand of the enemy. And the water covered them that afflicted them, there was not one of them left. And they believed his words, and they sang his praises. They had quickly done, they forgot his works, and they waited not for his counsels. And they coveted their desire in the desert, and they tempted God in the place without water. And he gave them their request, and sent fullness into their souls. And they provoked Moses in the camp, Aaron the Holy One of the Lord. The earth opened and swallowed up Dathan, and covered the congregation of Abiram. And a fire was kindled in their congregation, the flame burned the wicked. They made also a calf in Horeb, and they adored the graven thing. And they changed their glory into the likeness of a calf that eateth grass. They forgot God, who saved them, who had done great things in Egypt, wondrous works in the land of Cham, terrible things in the Red Sea. And he said that he would destroy them, had not Moses his chosen stood before him in the breach, to turn away his wrath, lest he should destroy them. And they set at naught the desirable land. They believed not his word, and they murmured in their tents, they hearkened not to the voice of the Lord. And he lifted up his hand over them, to overthrow them in the desert, and to cast down their seed among the nations, and to scatter them in the countries. They also were initiated to Belphegor, and ate the sacrifices of the dead. And they provoked him with their inventions, and destruction was multiplied among them. Then Phinehas stood up, and pacified him, and the slaughter ceased. Initiated, that is, they dedicated, or consecrated themselves to the idol of the Moabites and Madianites, called Belphegor, or Baal-peor. Num, Ibid. The dead, viz., idols without life. And it was reputed to him unto justice, to generation and generation forevermore. They provoked him also at the waters of contradiction, and Moses was afflicted for their sakes, because they exasperated his spirit. And he distinguished with his lips. They did not destroy the nations of which the Lord spoke unto them. And they were mingled among the heathens, and learned their works. He distinguished with his lips, Moses, by occasion of the people's rebellion and incredulity, was guilty of distinguishing with his lips, when, instead of speaking to the rock, as God had commanded, he said to the people, with a certain hesitation in his faith, "Hear ye, rebellious and incredulous, can we from this rock bring out water for you?" Num. And served their idols, and it became a stumbling block to them. And they sacrificed their sons, and their daughters to devils. And they shed innocent blood, the blood of their sons and of their daughters which they sacrificed to the idols of Chanaan. And the land was polluted with blood, and was defiled with their works, and they went aside after their own inventions. And the Lord was exceedingly angry with his people, and he abhorred his inheritance. And he delivered them into the hands of the nations, and they that hated them had dominion over them. And their enemies afflicted them, and they were humbled under their hands, many times did he deliver them. But they provoked him with their counsel, and they were brought low by their iniquities. And he saw when they were in tribulation, and he heard their prayer. And he was mindful of his covenant, and repented according to the multitude of his mercies. And he gave them unto mercies, in the sight of all those that had made them captives. Save us, O Lord, our God, and gather us from among nations, that we may give thanks to thy holy name, and may glory in thy praise. Blessed be the Lord the God of Israel, from everlasting to everlasting, and let all the people say, "So be it, so be it." Confitmini Domino. All are invited to give thanks to God for his perpetual providence over men. Alleluia. Give glory to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Let them say so that have been redeemed by the Lord, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy, and gathered out of the countries. From the rising and the setting of the sun, from the north and from the sea. They wandered in a wilderness, in a place without water, they found not the way of a city for their habitation. They were hungry and thirsty, their soul fainted in them. And they cried to the Lord in their tribulation, and he delivered them out of their distresses. And he led them into the right way, that they might go to a city of habitation. Let the mercies of the Lord give glory to him, and his wonderful works to the children of men. For he hath satisfied the empty soul, and hath filled the hungry soul with good things. Such as sat in darkness and in the shadow of death, bound in want and in iron. Because they had exasperated the words of God, and provoked the counsel of the Most High, and their heart was humbled with labors, they were weakened, and there was none to help them. Then they cried to the Lord in their affliction, and he delivered them out of their distresses. And he brought them out of darkness, and the shadow of death, and broke their bonds in sunder. Let the mercies of the Lord give glory to him, and his wonderful works to the children of men. Because he hath broken gates of brass, and burst the iron bars. He took them out of the way of their iniquity, for they were brought low for their injustices. Their soul abhorred all manner of meat, and they drew nigh even to the gates of death. And they cried to the Lord in their affliction, and he delivered them out of their distresses. He sent his word, and healed them, and delivered them from their destructions. Let the mercies of the Lord give glory to him, and his wonderful works to the children of men. And let them sacrifice the sacrifice of praise, and declare his works with joy. They that go down to the sea in ships, doing business in the great waters, these have seen the works of the Lord, and his wonders in the deep. He said the word, and there arose a storm of wind, and the waves thereof were lifted up. They mount up to the heavens, and they go down to the depths, their soul pined away with evils. They were troubled, and reeled like a drunken man, and all their wisdom was swallowed up. And they cried to the Lord in their affliction, and he brought them out of their distresses. And he turned the storm into a breeze, and its waves were still. And they rejoiced because they were still, and he brought them to the haven which they wished for. Let the mercies of the Lord give glory to him, and his wonderful works to the children of men. And let them exalt him in the church of the people, and praise him in the chair of the ancients. He hath turned rivers into a wilderness, and the sources of water into dry ground, a fruitful land into barrenness, for the wickedness of them that dwell therein. He hath turned a wilderness into pools of water, and a dry land into water springs. And hath placed there the hungry, and they made a city for their habitation. And they sowed fields, and planted vineyards, and they yielded fruit of birth. And he blessed them, and they were multiplied exceedingly, and their cattle he suffered not to decrease. Then they were brought to be few, and they were afflicted through the trouble of evils and sorrow. Contempt was poured forth upon their princes, and he caused them to wander where there was no passing, and out of the way. And he helped the poor out of poverty, and made him families like a flock of sheep. The just shall see, and shall rejoice, and all iniquity shall stop their mouth. Who is wise, and will keep these things, and will understand the mercies of the Lord? Paradum cor mum. The prophet praiseth God for benefits received. A canticle of a psalm for David himself. My heart is ready, O God, my heart is ready, I will sing, and will give praise, with my glory. Arise, my glory, arise, psaltery and harp, I will arise in the morning early. I will praise thee, O Lord, among the people, and I will sing unto thee among the populations. For thy mercy is great above the heavens, and thy truth even unto the clouds. Be thou exalted, O God, above the heavens, and thy glory over all the earth, that thy beloved may be delivered. Save with thy right hand and hear me. God hath spoken in his holiness. I will rejoice, and I will divide Sychem, and I will mete out the veil of tabernacles. Galilee is mine, and Manasseh is mine, and Ephraim the protection of my head. Judah is my king, Moab the pot of my hope. Over Edom I will stretch out my shoe, the aliens are become my friends. Who will bring me into this strong city? Who will lead me into Edom? Wilt not thou, O God, who hast cast us off? And wilt not thou, O God, go forth with our armies. O grant us help from trouble, for vain is the help of man. Through God we shall do mightily, and he will bring our enemies to nothing. Deus, laudem meum. David in the person of Christ, proof against his persecutors, more especially the traitor Judas, foretelling and approving his just punishment for his obstinacy in sin and final impenitence. Unto the end, a psalm for David. O God, be not thou silent in my praise, for the mouth of the wicked and the mouth of the deceitful man is opened against me. They have spoken against me with deceitful tongues, and they have compassed me about with words of hatred, and have fought against me without cause. Instead of making me a return of love, they detracted me, but I gave myself to prayer. And they repaid me evil for good, and hatred for my love. Set thou the sinner over him, and may the devil stand at his right hand. When he is judged, may he go out condemned, and may his prayer be turned to sin. May his days be few, and his bishopric let another take. May his children be fatherless, and his wife a widow. Let his children be carried about vagabonds, and beg, and let them be cast out of their dwellings. Set thou the sinner over him, give to the devil, that arch sinner, power over him, let him enter into him, and possess him. The imprecations, contained in the 30 verses of this psalm, are opposed to the 30 pieces of silver for which Judas betrayed our Lord, and are to be taken as prophetic denunciations of the evils that should befall the traitor and his accomplices the Jews, and not properly as curses. May the usurer search all his substance, and let strangers plunder his labors. May there be none to help him, nor none to pity his fatherless offspring. May his posterity be cut off, in one generation may his name be blotted out. May the iniquity of his fathers be remembered in the sight of the Lord, and let not the sin of his mother be blotted out. May they be before the Lord continually, and let the memory of them perish from the earth. Because he remembered not to show mercy, but persecuted the poor man and the beggar, and the broken in heart, to put him to death. And he loved cursing, and it shall come unto him, and he would not have blessing, and it shall be far from him. And he put on cursing, like a garment, and it went in like water into his entrails, and like oil in his bones. May it be unto him like a garment which covereth him, and like a girdle with which he is girded continually. This is the work of them who detract me before the Lord, and who speak evils against my soul. But thou, O Lord, do with me for thy name's sake, because thy mercy is sweet. Do thou deliver me, for I am poor and needy, and my heart is troubled within me. I am taken away like the shadow when it declineth, and I am shaken off as locusts. My knees are weakened through fasting, and my flesh is changed for oil. And I am become a reproach to them, they saw me and they shake their heads. For oil, propter oleum. The meaning is, my flesh is changed, being perfectly emaciated and dried up, as having lost all its oil or fatness. Help me, O Lord my God, save me according to thy mercy. And let them know that this is thy hand, and that thou, O Lord, hast done it. They will curse and thou will bless, let them that rise up against me be confounded, but thy servant shall rejoice. Let them that detract me be clothed with shame, and let them be covered with their confusion as with a double cloak. I will give great thanks to the Lord with my mouth, and in the midst of many I will praise him. Because he hath stood at the right hand of the poor, to save my soul from persecutors. Dixit Dominus. Christ's exaltation and everlasting priesthood. The Lord said to my Lord, Sit thou at my right hand, until I make thy enemies thy footstool. The Lord will send forth the scepter of thy power out of Sion, rule thou in the midst of thy enemies. With thee is the principality in the day of thy strength, in the brightness of the saints, from the womb before the day star I begot thee. The Lord hath sworn, and he will not repent, thou art a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek. The Lord at thy right hand hath broken kings in the day of his wrath. He shall judge among nations, he shall fill ruins, he shall crush the heads in the land of the many. He shall drink of the torrent and the way, therefore shall he lift up the head. Confiteor tibi, Domini. God is to be praised for his graces, and benefits to his church. Alleluia. I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart, in the council of the just, and in the congregation. Great are the works of the Lord, sought out according to all his wills. His work is praise and magnificence, and his justice continueth forever and ever. He hath made a remembrance of his wonderful works, being a merciful and gracious Lord, he hath given food to them that fear him. He will be mindful forever of his covenant. He will show forth to his people the power of his works, that he may give them the inheritance of the Gentiles. The works of his hands are truth and judgment. All his commandments are faithful, confirmed forever and ever, made in truth and equity. He hath sent redemption to his people, he hath commanded his covenant forever. Holy and terrible is his name, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding to all that do it, his praise continueth forever and ever. Beatus ver. The good man is happy. Alleluia. Of the returning of Agius and Zacharias. Of the returning, etc. This is in the Greek and Latin, but not in the Hebrew. It signifies that this psalm was proper to be sung at the time of the return of the people from their captivity, to inculcate to them how happy they might be, if they would be constant in the service of God. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, he shall delight exceedingly in his commandments. His seed shall be mighty upon earth, the generation of the righteous shall be blessed. Glory and wealth shall be in his house, and his justice remaineth forever and ever. To the righteous a light is risen up in darkness, he is merciful, and compassionate and just. Acceptable is the man that sheweth mercy and lendeth, he shall order his words with judgment. Because he shall not be moved forever. The just shall be in everlasting remembrance, he shall not hear the evil hearing. His heart is ready to hope in the Lord, his heart is strengthened, he shall not be moved until he look over his enemies. He hath distributed, he hath given to the poor, his justice remaineth forever and ever, his horn shall be exalted in glory. The wicked shall see, and shall be angry, he shall gnash with his teeth and pine away, the desire of the wicked shall perish. Laudate, pray. God is to be praised for his regard to the poor and humble. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, ye children. Praise ye the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from henceforth now and forever. From the rising of the sun unto the going down of the same, the name of the Lord is worthy of praise. The Lord is high above all nations, and his glory above the heavens. Who is as the Lord our God, who dwelleth on high, and looketh down on the low things in heaven and in earth? Raising up the needy from the earth, and lifting up the poor out of the dunghill, that he may place him with the princes of his people. Who maketh a barren woman to dwell in a house, the joyful mother of children. In exitu Israel. God hath shown his power in delivering his people, idols are vain. The Hebrews divide this into two psalms. Alleluia. When Israel went out of Egypt, the house of Jacob from a barbarous people, Judea made his sanctuary, Israel his dominion. The sea saw and fled. Jordan was turned back. The mountains skipped like rams, and the hills like the lambs of the flock. What ailed thee, O thou sea, that thou didst flee, and thou, O Jordan, that thou wast turned back? Ye mountains, that ye skipped like rams, and ye hills, like lambs of the flock? At the presence of the Lord the earth was moved, at the presence of the God of Jacob, who turned the rock into pools of water, and the stony hill into fountains of waters. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to thy name give glory. For thy mercy, and for thy truth's sake, lest the Gentiles should say, Where is their God? But our God is in heaven, he hath done all things whatsoever he would. The idols of the Gentiles are silver and gold, the works of the hands of men. They have mouths and speak not, they have eyes and see not. They have ears and hear not, they have noses and smell not. They have hands and feel not, they have feet and walk not, neither shall they cry out through their throat. Let them that make them become like unto them, and all such as trust in them. The house of Israel hath hoped in the Lord, he is their helper and their protector. The house of Aaron hath hoped in the Lord, he is their helper and their protector. They that fear the Lord hath hoped in the Lord, he is their helper and their protector. The Lord hath been mindful of us, and hath blessed us. He hath blessed the house of Israel, he hath blessed the house of Aaron. He hath blessed all that fear the Lord, both little and great. May the Lord add blessings upon you, and upon your children. Blessed be you of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. The heaven of heaven is the Lord's, but the earth he has given to the children of men. The dead shall not praise thee, O Lord, nor any of them that go down to hell. But we that live bless the Lord, from this time now and forever. Doxai. The prayer of a just man in affliction, with a lively confidence in God. Alleluia. I have loved, because the Lord will hear the voice of my prayer. Because he hath inclined his ear unto me, and in my days I will call upon him. The sorrows of death have encompassed me, and the perils of hell have found me. I met with trouble and sorrow, and I called upon the name of the Lord. O Lord, deliver my soul. The Lord is merciful and just, and our God showeth mercy. The Lord is the keeper of little ones, I was little and he delivered me. Turn, O my soul, into thy rest, for the Lord hath been bountiful to thee. For he hath delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from falling. I will please the Lord in the land of the living. Credidi. This in the Hebrew is joined with the foregoing psalm, and continues to express the faith and gratitude of the psalmist. Alleluia. I have believed, therefore have I spoken, but I have been humbled exceedingly. I said in my excess, every man is a liar. What shall I render to the Lord, for all the things he hath rendered unto me? I will take the chalice of salvation, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord before all his people, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. O Lord, for I am thy servant, and the son of thy handmaid. Thou hast broken my bonds, I will sacrifice to thee the sacrifice of praise, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the sight of all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in the midst of thee, O Jerusalem. Laudate Dominum. All nations are called upon to praise God for his mercy and truth. Alleluia. O praise the Lord, all ye nations, praise him, all ye people. For his mercy is confirmed upon us, and the truth of the Lord remaineth forever. Confitmini Domino. The psalmist praiseth God for his delivery from evils, putteth his whole trust in him, and foretelleth the coming of Christ. Alleluia. Give praise to Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Let Israel now say that he is good, that his mercy endureth forever. Let the house of Aaron now say, that his mercy endureth forever. Let them that fear the Lord now say, that his mercy endureth forever. In my trouble I called upon the Lord, and the Lord heard me, and enlarged me. The Lord is my helper, I will not fear what man can do unto me. The Lord is my helper, and I will look over my enemies. It is good to confide in the Lord, rather than to have confidence in man. It is good to trust in the Lord, rather than to trust in princes. All nations compassed me about, and in the name of the Lord I have been revenged on them. Surrounding me they compassed me about, and in the name of the Lord I have been revenged on them. They surrounded me like bees, and they burned like fire among thorns, and in the name of the Lord I was revenged on them. Being pushed I was overturned that I might fall, but the Lord supported me. The Lord is my strength and my praise, and he has become my salvation. The voice of rejoicing and of salvation is in the tabernacles of the just. The right hand of the Lord hath wrought strength, the right hand of the Lord hath exalted me, the right hand of the Lord hath wrought strength. I shall not die, but live, and shall declare the works of the Lord. The Lord chastising hath chastised me, but he hath not delivered me over to death. Open ye to me the gates of justice, I will go into them, and give praise to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord, the just shall enter into it. I will give glory to thee because thou hast heard me, and art become my salvation. The stone which the builders rejected, the same is become the head of the corner. This is the Lord's doing, and it is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord hath made, let us be glad and rejoice therein. O Lord, save me, O Lord, give good success. Blessed be he that cometh in the name Lord. We have blessed you out of the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he hath shone upon us. Appoint a solemn day, with shady boughs, even to the horn of the altar. Thou art my God, and I will praise Thee, Thou art my God, and I will exalt Thee. I will praise Thee, because Thou hast heard me, and art become my salvation. O praise ye the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endureth forever. Beati Immaculati. Of the excellence of virtue consisting in the love and observance of the commandments of God. Alleluia. Aleph. Blessed are the undefiled in the way, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they who search His testimonies, that seek Him with their whole heart. For they that work iniquity, have not walked in His ways. Thou hast commanded Thy commandments to be kept most diligently. Oh! That my ways may be directed to keep Thy justifications. His testimonies, the commandments of God are called His testimonies, because they testify His holy will unto us. Note here, that in almost every verse of this psalm, which in number are, the word and law of God, and the love and observance of it, is perpetually inculcated, under a variety of denominations, all signifying the same thing. Then shall I not be confounded, when I shall look into all Thy commandments. I will praise Thee with uprightness of heart, when I shall have learned the judgments of Thy justice. I will keep Thy justifications, O. Do not Thou utterly forsake me. Beth. By what doth a young man correct his way? By observing Thy words. With my whole heart have I sought after Thee, let me not stray from Thy commandments. Thy words have I hidden in my heart, that I may not sin against Thee. Blessed art Thou, O Lord, teach me Thy justifications. With my lips I have pronounced all the judgments of Thy mouth. I have been delighted in the way of Thy testimonies, as in all riches. I will meditate on Thy commandments, and I will consider Thy ways. I will think of Thy justifications, I will not forget Thy words. Gimel. Give bountifully to Thy servant, enliven me, and I shall keep Thy words. Open Thou my eyes, and I will consider the wondrous things of Thy law. I am a sojourner on the earth, hide not Thy commandments from me. My soul hath coveted to long for Thy justifications, at all times. Thou hast rebuked the proud, they are cursed who decline from Thy commandments. Remove from reproach and contempt, because I have sought after Thy testimonies. For princes sat, and spoke against me, but Thy servant was employed in Thy justifications. For Thy testimonies are my meditation, and Thy justifications my counsel. Daleth. My soul hath cleaved to the pavement, quicken Thou me according to Thy word. I have declared my ways, and Thou hast heard me, teach me Thy justifications. Make me to understand the way of Thy justifications, and I shall be exercised in Thy wondrous works. My soul hath slumbered through heaviness, strengthen Thou me in Thy words. Remove from me the way of iniquity, and out of Thy law have mercy on me. I have chosen the way of truth, Thy judgments I have not forgotten. I have stuck to Thy testimonies, O Lord, put me not to shame. I have run the way of Thy commandments, when Thou didst enlarge my heart. He set before me for a law the way of Thy justifications, O Lord, and I will always seek after it. Give me understanding, and I will search Thy law, and I will keep it with my whole heart. Lead me into the path of Thy commandments, for this same I have desired. Incline my heart into Thy testimonies and not to covetousness. Turn away my eyes that they may not behold vanity, quicken me in Thy way. Establish Thy word to Thy servant, in Thy fear. Turn away my reproach, which I have apprehended, for Thy judgments are delightful. Behold, I have longed after Thy precepts, quicken me in Thy justice. Vah. Let Thy mercy also come upon me, O Lord, Thy salvation according to Thy word. So shall I answer them that reproach me in anything, that I have trusted in Thy words. And take not Thou the word of truth utterly out of my mouth, for in Thy words have I hoped exceedingly. So shall I always keep Thy law, for ever and ever. And I walked at large, because I have sought after Thy commandments. And I spoke of Thy testimonies before kings, and I was not ashamed. I meditated also on Thy commandments, which I loved. And I lifted up my hands to Thy commandments, which I loved, and I was exercised in Thy justifications. Zayn. Be Thou mindful of Thy word to Thy servant, in which Thou hast given me hope. This hath comforted me in my humiliation, because thy word hath enlivened me. The proud did iniquitously altogether, but I declined not from thy law. I remembered, O Lord, thy judgments of old, and I was comforted. A fainting hath taken hold of me, because of the wicked that forsake thy law. Thy justifications were the subject of my song, in the place of my pilgrimage. In the night I have remembered thy name, O Lord, and have kept thy law. This happened to me, because I sought after thy justifications. Heth. O Lord, my portion, I have said, I would keep the law. I entreated thy face with all my heart, have mercy on me according to thy word. I have thought on my ways, and turned my feet unto thy testimonies. I am ready, and am not troubled, that I may keep thy commandments. The cords of the wicked have encompassed me, but I have not forgotten thy law. I rose at midnight to give praise to thee, for the judgments of thy justification. I am a partaker with all them that fear thee, and that keep thy commandments. The earth, O Lord, is full of thy mercy, teach me thy justifications. Tess. Thou hast done well with thy servant, O Lord, according to thy word. Teach me goodness and discipline and knowledge, for I have believed thy commandments. Before I was humbled I offended, therefore have I kept thy word. Thou art good, and in thy goodness teach me thy justifications. The iniquity of the proud hath been multiplied over me, but I will seek thy commandments with my whole heart. Their heart is curdled like milk, but I have meditated on thy law. It is good for me that thou hast humbled me, that I may learn thy justifications. The law of thy mouth is good to me, above thousands of gold and silver. Jod. Thy hands have made me and formed me, give me understanding, and I will learn thy commandments. They that fear thee shall see me, and shall be glad, because I have greatly hoped in thy words. I know, O Lord, that thy judgments are equity, and in thy truth thou hast humbled me. O, let thy mercy be for my comfort, according to thy word unto thy servant. Let thy tender mercies come unto me, and I shall live, for thy law is my meditation. Let the proud be ashamed, because they have done unjustly towards me, but I will be employed in thy commandments. Let them that fear thee turn to me and they that know thy testimonies. Let my heart be undefiled in thy justifications, that I may not be confounded. Caph. My soul hath fainted after thy salvation, and in thy word I have very much hoped. My eyes have failed for thy word, saying, when wilt thou comfort me? For I am become like a bottle in the frost, I have not forgotten thy justifications. How many are the days of thy servant? When wilt thou execute judgment on them that persecute me? The wicked have told me fables, but not as thy law. All thy statutes are truth, they have persecuted me unjustly, do thou help me. They had almost made an end of me upon earth, but I have not forsaken thy commandments. Quicken thou me according to thy mercy, and I shall keep the testimonies of thy mouth. Lamed. Forever, O Lord, thy word standeth firm in heaven. Thy truth unto all generations, thou hast founded the earth, and it continueth. By thy ordinance the day goeth on, for all things serve thee. Unless thy law had been my meditation, I had then perhaps perished in my abjection. Thy justifications I will never forget, for by them thou hast given me life. I am thine, save thou me, for I have sought thy justifications. The wicked have waited for me to destroy me, but I have understood thy testimonies. I have seen an end to all persecution, thy commandment is exceeding broad. Memo, how have I loved thy law, O Lord! It is my meditation all the day. Through thy commandment, thou hast made me wiser than my enemies, for it is ever with me. I have understood more than all my teachers, because thy testimonies are my meditation. I have had understanding above ancients, because I have sought thy commandments. I have restrained my feet from every evil way, that I may keep thy words. I have not declined from thy judgments, because thou hast set me a law. How sweet are thy words to my palate! More than honey to my mouth. By thy commandments I have had understanding, therefore have I hated every way of iniquity. None. Thy word is a lamp to my feet, and a light to my paths. I have sworn and am determined to keep the judgments of thy justice. I have been humbled, O Lord, exceedingly, quicken thou me according to thy word. The free offerings of my mouth make acceptable, O Lord, and teach me thy judgments. My soul is continually in my hands, and I have not forgotten thy law. Sinners have laid a snare for me, but I have not heard from thy precepts. I have purchased thy testimonies for an inheritance forever, because they are a joy to my heart. I have inclined my heart to do thy justifications forever, for the reward. Samak. I have hated the unjust, and have loved thy law. Thou art my helper and my protector, and in thy word I have greatly hoped. Depart from me, ye malignant, and I will search the commandments of my God. Uphold me according to thy word, and I shall live, and let me not be confounded in my expectation. Help me, and I shall be saved, and I will meditate always on thy justifications. Thou hast despised all them that fall off from thy judgments, for their thought is unjust. I have accounted all the sinners of the earth prevaricators, therefore have I loved thy testimonies. Pierce thou my flesh with thy fear, for I am afraid of thy judgments. Ain. I have done judgment and justice, give me not up to them that slander me. Uphold thy servant unto good, let not the proud calumniate me. My eyes have fainted after thy salvation, and for the word of thy justice. Deal with thy servant according to thy mercy, and teach me thy justifications. I am thy servant, give me understanding that I may know thy testimonies. It is time, O Lord, to do, they have dissipated thy law. Therefore have I loved thy commandments above gold and the topaz. Therefore was I directed to all thy commandments, I have hated all wicked ways. PHE. Thy testimonies are wonderful, therefore my soul hath sought them. The declaration of thy words giveth light, and giveth understanding to little ones. I opened my mouth and panted, because I longed for thy commandments. Look thou upon me, and have mercy on me, according to the judgment of them that love thy name. Direct my steps according to thy word, and let no iniquity have dominion over me. Redeem me from the calumnies of men, that I may keep thy commandments. Make thy face to shine upon thy servant, and teach me thy justifications. My eyes have sent forth springs of water, because they have not kept thy law. Said, thou art just, O Lord, and thy judgment is right. Thou hast commanded justice thy testimonies, and thy truth exceedingly. My zeal hath made me pine away, because my enemies forgot thy words. Thy word is exceedingly refined, and thy servant hath loved it. I am very young and despised, but I forgot not thy justifications. Thy justice is justice forever, and thy law is the truth. Trouble and anguish have found me, thy commandments are my meditation. Thy testimonies are justice forever, give me understanding, and I shall live. Cough. I cried with my whole heart, hear me, O Lord, I will seek thy justifications. I cried unto thee, save me, that I may keep thy commandments. I prevented the dawning of the day, and cried, because in thy words I very much hoped. My eyes to thee have prevented the morning, that I might meditate on thy words. Hear thou my voice, O Lord, according to thy mercy, and quicken me according to thy mercy. They that persecute me have drawn nigh to iniquity, but they are gone far off from the law. Thou art near, O Lord, and all thy ways are truth. I have known from the beginning concerning thy testimonies, that thou hast founded them forever. Rise. See my humiliation and deliver me, for I have not forgotten the law. Judge my judgment and redeem me, quicken thou me for thy word's sake. Salvation is far from sinners, because they have not sought thy justifications. Many, O Lord, are thy mercies, quicken me according to thy judgment. Many are they that persecute me, and afflict me, but I have not declined from thy testimonies. I beheld the transgressors, and I pined away, because they kept not thy word. Behold, I have loved thy commandments, O Lord, quicken me thou in thy mercy. The beginning of thy words is truth, all the judgments of thy justice are forever. Sin. Princes have persecuted me without cause, and my heart hath been in awe of thy words. I will rejoice at thy words, as one that hath found great spoil. I have hated and abhorred iniquity, but I have loved thy law. 7 times a day I have given praise to thee, for the judgments of thy justice. Much peace have they that love thy law, and to them there is no stumbling block. I look to thy salvation, O Lord, and I love thy commandments. My soul hath kept thy testimonies, and hath loved them exceedingly. I have kept thy commandments and thy testimonies, because all my ways are in thy sight. Tau. Let my supplication, O Lord, come near in thy sight, give me understanding according to thy word. Let my request come in before thee, deliver thou me according to thy word. My lips shall utter a hymn, when thou shalt teach me thy justifications. My tongue shall pronounce thy word, because all thy commandments are justice. Let thy hand be with me to save me, for I have chosen thy precepts. I have longed for thy salvation, O Lord, and thy law is my meditation. My soul shall live and shall praise thee, and thy judgments shall help me. I have gone astray like a sheep that is lost, seek thy servant, because I have not forgotten thy commandments. Ad Dominum. A prayer in tribulation. A gradual canticle. The following psalms, in number 15, are called gradual psalms, or canticles, from the word gradus, signifying steps, ascensions, or degrees, either because they were appointed to be sung on the 15 steps, by which the people ascended to the temple, or, that in the singing of them the voice was to be raised by certain steps or ascensions, or, that they were to be sung by the people returning from their captivity and ascending to Jerusalem, which was seated amongst mountains. The Holy Fathers, in a mystical sense, understand these steps, or ascensions, of the degrees by which Christians spiritually ascend to virtue and perfection, and to the true temple of God in the heavenly Jerusalem. In my trouble I cried to the Lord, and he heard me. O Lord, deliver my soul from wicked lips, and a deceitful tongue. What shall be given to thee, or what shall be added to thee, to a deceitful tongue? The sharp arrows of the mighty, with coals that lay waste. Woe is me, that my sojourning is prolonged. I have dwelt with the inhabitants of Cedar. My soul hath been long a sojourner. With them that hated peace I was peaceable, when I spoke to them they fought against me without cause. Levaviaculos. God is the keeper of his servants. A gradual canticle. I have lifted up my eyes to the mountains, from whence help shall come to me. My help is from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. May he not suffer thy foot to be moved, neither let him slumber that keepeth thee. Behold, he shall neither slumber nor sleep, that keepeth Israel. The Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy protection upon thy right hand. The sun shall not burn thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord keepeth thee from all evil, may the Lord keep thy soul. May the Lord keep thy coming in and thy going out, from henceforth now and forever. Letatus summoned his. The desire and hope of the just for the coming of the kingdom of God, and the peace of his church. I rejoiced at the things that were said to me, we shall go into the house of the Lord. Our feet were standing in thy courts, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem, which is built as a city, which is compact together. For thither did the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, the testimony of Israel, to praise the name of the Lord. Because their seats have sat in judgment, seats upon the house of David. Pray ye for the things that are for the peace of Jerusalem, and abundance for them that love thee. Let peace be in thy strength, and abundance in thy towers. For the sake of my brethren, and of my neighbors, I spoke peace of thee. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I have sought good things for thee. Ad te levavi. A prayer in affliction, with confidence in God. A gradual canticle. To thee have I lifted up my eyes, who dwellest in heaven. Behold, as the eyes of the servants are on the hands of their masters, as the eyes of the handmaid are on the hands of her mistress, so are our eyes unto the Lord our God, until he have mercy on us. Have mercy on us, O Lord, have mercy on us, for we are greatly filled with contempt. For our soul is greatly filled, we are a reproach to the rich, and contempt to the proud. Nisi quia Domini. The church giveth glory to God for her deliverance from the hands of her enemies. If it had not been that the Lord was with us, let Israel now say, if it had not been that the Lord was with us, when men rose up against us, perhaps they had swallowed us up alive. When their fury was enkindled against us, perhaps the waters had swallowed us up. Our soul hath passed through a torrent, perhaps our soul had passed through a water insupportable. Blessed be the Lord, who hath not given us to be a prey to their teeth. Our soul hath been delivered as a sparrow out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken, and we are delivered. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. The just are always under God's protection. They that trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion, he shall not be moved forever that dwelleth in Jerusalem. Mountains are round about it, so the Lord is round about his people from henceforth now and forever. For the Lord will not leave the rod of sinners upon the lot of the just, that the just may not stretch forth their hands to iniquity. Do good, O Lord, to those that are good, and to the upright of heart. But such as turn aside into bonds, the Lord shall lead out with the workers of iniquity, peace upon Israel. The people of God rejoice at their delivery from captivity. When the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we became like men comforted. Then was our mouth filled with gladness, and our tongue with joy. Then shall they say among the Gentiles, the Lord hath done great things for them. The Lord hath done great things for us, we are become joyful. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, as a stream in the south. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Going they went and wept, casting their seeds. But coming they shall come with joyfulness, carrying their sheaves. Nisi Dominus. Nothing can be done without God's grace and blessing. Unless the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Unless the Lord keep the city, he watcheth in vain that keepeth it. It is vain for you to rise before light, rise ye after you have sitten, you that eat the bread of sorrow. When he shall give sleep to his beloved, behold the inheritance of the Lord are children, the reward, the fruit of the womb. As arrows in the hand of the mighty, so the children of them that have been shaken. Blessed is the man that hath filled the desire with them, he shall not be confounded when he shall speak to his enemies in the gate. It is vain for you to rise before light, that is, your early rising, your labor and worldly solicitude, will be vain, that is, will avail you nothing, without the light, grace, and blessing of God. Beati omnes. The fear of God is the way to happiness. Blessed are all they that fear the Lord, that walk in his ways. For thou shalt eat the labors of thy hands, blessed art thou, and it shall be well with thee. Thy wife as a fruitful vine, on the sides of thy house. Behold, thus shall the man be blessed that feareth the Lord. May the Lord bless thee out of Zion, and mayest thou see the good things of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. And mayest thou see thy children's children, peace upon Israel. Sip expugni verunt. The church of God is invincible, her persecutors come to nothing. Often have they fought against me from my youth, let Israel now say. Often have they fought against me from my youth, but they could not prevail over me. The wicked have wrought upon my back, they have lengthened their iniquity. The Lord who is just will cut the necks of sinners, let them all be confounded and turned back that hate Zion. Let them be as grass on the tops of houses, which withered before it be plucked up, wherewith the mower filleth not his hand, nor he that gathereth sheaves his bosom. And they that have passed by have not said, the blessing of the Lord be upon you, we have blessed you in the name of the Lord. De profundis. A prayer of a sinner, trusting in the mercies of God. The sixth penitential psalm. Out of the depths I have cried to thee, O Lord, Lord, hear my voice. Let thy ears be attentive to the voice of my supplication. If thou, O Lord, wilt mark iniquities, Lord, who shall stand it? For with thee there is merciful forgiveness, and by reason of thy law, I have waited for thee, O Lord. My soul hath relied on his word, my soul hath hoped in the Lord. From the morning watch even until night, let Israel hope in the Lord. Because with the Lord there is mercy, and with him plentiful redemption. And he shall redeem Israel from all his iniquities. Domini, non estate. The prophet's humility. Lord, my heart is not exalted, nor are my eyes lofty. Neither have I walked in great matters, nor in wonderful things above me. If I was not humbly minded, but exalted my soul, as a child that is weaned is towards his mother, so reward in my soul. Let Israel hope in the Lord, from henceforth now and forever. Memento Domini. A prayer for the fulfilling of the promise made to David. O Lord, remember David, and all his meekness. How he swore to the Lord, he vowed a vow to the God of Jacob, if I shall enter into the tabernacle of my house, if I shall go up into the bed wherein I lie, if I shall give sleep to my eyes, or slumber to my eyelids, or rest to my temples, until I find out a place for the Lord, a tabernacle for the God of Jacob. Behold, we have heard of it in Ephratah, we have found it in the fields of the wood. We will go into his tabernacle, we will adore in the place where his feet stood. Arise, O Lord, into thy resting place, thou and the ark, which thou hast sanctified. Let thy priests be clothed with justice, and let thy saints rejoice. For thy servant David's sake, turn not away the face of thy anointed. We have heard of it in Ephratah, when I was young, and lived in Bethlehem, otherwise called Ephratah, I heard of God's tabernacle and ark, and had a devout desire of seeking it, and accordingly I found it at Kiriath-Jearim, the city of the woods, where it was till it was removed to Jerusalem. See 1 Chronicles chapter 13 in your St. Jerome's Bible. The Lord hath sworn truth to David, and he will not make a void, of the fruit of thy womb I will set upon thy throne. If thy children will keep thy covenant, and these my testimonies which I shall teach them, their children also forevermore shall sit upon thy throne. For the Lord hath chosen Sion, he hath chosen it for his dwelling. This is my rest forever and ever, here will I dwell, for I have chosen it. Blessing, I will bless her widow, I will satisfy her poor with bread. I will clothe her priests with salvation, and her saints shall rejoice with exceeding great joy. There will I bring forth a horn to David, I have prepared a lamp for my anointed. His enemies I will clothe with confusion, but upon him will my sanctification flourish. Ecce quam bonum. The happiness of brotherly love and concord, behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell in unity. Like the precious ointment on the head, that ran down upon the beard of Aaron, which ran down to the skirt of his garment, as the dew of Hermon, which descendeth upon Mount Sion. For there the Lord hath commandeth blessing, and life forevermore. Ecce nunc benedicite. An exhortation to praise God continually. Behold now bless ye the Lord, all ye servants of the Lord, who stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God. In the nights lift up your hands to the holy places, and bless ye the Lord. May the Lord out of Sion bless thee, he that made heaven and earth. Laudate Nomen. An exhortation to praise God, the vanity of idols. Praise ye the name of the Lord, O you his servants, praise the Lord. You that stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God. Praise ye the Lord, for the Lord is good, sing ye to his name, for it is sweet. For the Lord hath chosen Jacob unto himself, Israel for his own possession. For I have known that the Lord is great, and our God is above all gods. Whatsoever the Lord hath pleased he hath done, in heaven, in earth, in the sea, and in all the deeps. He bringeth up clouds from the end of the earth. He hath made lightnings for the rain. He bringeth forth winds out of his stores, he slew the firstborn of Egypt from man even unto beast. He sent forth signs and wonders in the midst of thee, O Egypt, upon Pharaoh, and upon all his servants. He smote many nations, and slew mighty kings. Sihon king of the Amorites, and Og king of Basan, and all the kingdoms of Canaan. And gave their land for an inheritance to his people Israel. Thy name, O Lord, is forever, thy memorial, O Lord, unto all generations. For the Lord will judge his people, and will be entreated in favor of his servants. The idols of the Gentiles are silver and gold, the works of men's hands. They have a mouth, but they speak not, they have eyes, but they see not. They have ears, but they hear not, neither is there any breath in their mouths. Let them that make them be like to them, and every one that trusteth in them. Bless the Lord, O house of Israel, bless the Lord, O house of Aaron. Bless the Lord, O house of Levi, you that fear the Lord, bless the Lord. Blessed be the Lord out of Sion, who dwelleth in Jerusalem. Confitmini Domino. God is to be praised for his wonderful works. Praise the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Praise ye the God of gods, for his mercy endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord of lords, for his mercy endureth forever. Who alone doth great wonders, for his mercy endureth forever. Who made the heavens in understanding, for his mercy endureth forever. Praise the Lord. By this invitation to praise the Lord, thrice repeated, we profess the blessed Trinity, one God in three distinct persons, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Who established the earth above the waters, for his mercy endureth forever. Who made the great lights, for his mercy endureth forever. The sun to rule over the day, for his mercy endureth forever. The moon and the stars to rule the night, for his mercy endureth forever. Who smote Egypt with their firstborn, for his mercy endureth forever. Who brought Israel from among them, for his mercy endureth forever. With a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, for his mercy endureth forever. Who divided the Red Sea into parts, for his mercy endureth forever. And brought out Israel through the midst thereof, for his mercy endureth forever. And overthrew Pharaoh and his host in the Red Sea, for his mercy endureth forever. Who led his people through the desert, for his mercy endureth forever. Who smote great kings, for his mercy endureth forever. And slew strong kings, for his mercy endureth forever. Sihon king of the Amorites, for his mercy endureth forever. And Og king of Basan, for his mercy endureth forever. And he gave their land for an inheritance, for his mercy endureth forever. For an inheritance to his servant Israel, for his mercy endureth forever. For he was mindful of us in our affliction, for his mercy endureth forever. And he redeemed us from our enemies, for his mercy endureth forever. Who giveth food to all flesh, for his mercy endureth forever. Give glory to the God of heaven, for his mercy endureth forever. Give glory to the Lord of lords, for his mercy endureth forever. Superflumina. The lamentation of the people of God in their captivity in Babylon. A psalm of David, for Jeremias. For the time of Jeremias, and the captivity of Babylon. Upon the rivers of Babylon, there we sat and wept, when we remembered Sion, on the willows in the midst thereof we hung up our instruments. For there they that led us into captivity required of us the words of songs. And they that carried us away, said, Sing ye to us a hymn of the songs of Sion. How shall we sing the song of the Lord in a strange land? If I forget thee, O Jerusalem, let my right hand be forgotten. Let my tongue cleave to my jaws, if I do not remember thee, if I make not Jerusalem the beginning of my joy. Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom, in the day of Jerusalem, who say, raise it, even to the foundation thereof. O daughter of Babylon, miserable, blessed shall he be who shall repay thee thy payment which thou hast paid us. Blessed be he that shall take and dash thy little ones against the rock. Dash thy little ones, in the spiritual sense, we dash the little ones of Babylon against the rock, when we mortify our passions, and stifle the first motions of them, by a speedy recourse to the rock which is Christ. Confiteor tibi. Thanksgiving to God for his benefits. I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart, for thou hast heard the words of my mouth. I will sing praise to thee in the sight of his angels, I will worship towards thy holy temple, and I will give glory to thy name. For thy mercy, and for thy truth, for thou hast magnified thy holy name above all. In what day soever I shall call upon thee, hear me, thou shalt multiply strength in my soul. May all the kings of the earth give glory to thee, for they have heard all the words of thy mouth. And let them sing in the ways of the Lord, for great is the glory of the Lord. For the Lord is high, and looketh on the low, and the high he knoweth afar off. If I shall walk in the midst of tribulation, thou wilt quicken me, and thou hast stretched forth thy hand against the wrath of my enemies, and thy right hand hath saved me. The Lord will repay for me, thy mercy, O Lord, endureth forever, O despise not the work of thy hands. Domini. Providasti. God's special providence over his servants. Lord, thou hast proved me, and known me, thou hast known my sitting down, and my rising up. Thou hast understood my thoughts afar off, my path and my line thou hast searched out. And thou hast foreseen all my ways, for there is no speech in my tongue. Behold, O Lord, thou hast known all things, the last and those of old, thou hast formed me, and hast laid thy hand upon me. There is no speech, viz., unknown to thee, or when there is no speech in my tongue, yet my whole interior and my most secret thoughts are known to thee. Thy knowledge is become wonderful to me, it is high, and I cannot reach to it. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy face? If I ascend into heaven, thou art there, if I descend into hell, thou art present. If I take my wings early in the morning, and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there also shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. And I said, perhaps darkness shall cover me, and night shall be my light and my pleasures. But darkness shall not be dark to thee, and night shall be light as day, the darkness thereof, and the light thereof are alike to thee. For thou hast possessed my reins, thou hast protected me from my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for thou art fearfully magnified, wonderful are thy works, and my soul knoweth right well. My bone is not hidden from thee, which thou hast made in secret, and my substance in the lower parts of the earth. Thy eyes did see my imperfect being, and in thy book all shall be written, days shall be formed, and no one in them. But to me thy friends, O God, are made exceedingly honorable, their principality is exceedingly strengthened. I will number them, and they shall be multiplied above the sand, I rose up and am still with thee. If thou wilt kill the wicked, O God, ye men of blood, depart from me, because you say in thought, they shall receive thy cities in vain. Because you say in thought, depart from me, you wicked, who plot against the servants of God, and think to cast them out of the cities of their habitation, as if they have received them in vain, and to no purpose. Have I not hated them, O Lord, that hated thee, and pine away because of thy enemies? I have hated them with a perfect hatred, and they are become enemies to me. Prove me, O God, and know my heart, examine me, and know my paths. And see if there be in me the way of iniquity, and lead me in the eternal way. I have hated them, not with an hatred of malice, but a zeal for the observance of God's commandments, which he saw were despised by the wicked, who are to be considered enemies to God. Write me, Domini. A prayer to be delivered from the wicked. Unto the end, a psalm for David. Deliver me, O Lord, from the evil man, rescue me from the unjust man. Who have devised iniquities in their hearts, all the day long they designed battles. They have sharpened their tongues like a serpent, the venom of saps is under their lips. Keep me, O Lord, from the hand of the wicked, and from unjust men deliver me. Who have proposed to supplant my steps. The proud have hidden a net for me. And they have stretched out cords for a snare, they have laid for me a stumbling block by the wayside. I said to the Lord, thou art my God, hear, O Lord, the voice of my supplication. O Lord, Lord, the strength of my salvation, thou hast overshadowed my head in the day of battle. Give me not up, O Lord, from my desire to the wicked, they have plotted against me, do not thou forsake me, lest they should triumph. The head of them compassing me about, the labor of their lips shall overwhelm them. Burning coals shall fall upon them, thou wilt cast them down into the fire, in miseries they shall not be able to stand. A man full of tongue shall not be established in the earth, evil shall catch the unjust man unto destruction. I know that the Lord will do justice to the needy, and will revenge the poor. But as for the just, they shall give glory to thy name, and the upright shall dwell with thy countenance. Domini, clamavi. A prayer against sinful words, and deceitful flatterers. A psalm of David. I have cried to thee, O Lord, hear me, hearken to my voice, when I cry to thee. Let my prayer be directed as incense in thy sight, the lifting up of my hands, as evening sacrifice. Set a watch, O Lord, before my mouth, and a door round about my lips. Incline not my heart to evil words, to make excuses and sins. With men that work iniquity, and I will not communicate with the choicest of them. The just shall correct me in mercy, and shall reprove me, but let not the oil of the sinner fatten my head. For my prayer also shall still be against the things with which they are well pleased. Let not the oil of the sinner, that is, the flattery, or deceitful praise it. For my prayer, so far from coveting their praises, who are never well pleased but with things that are evil, I shall continually pray to be preserved from such things as they are delighted with. Their judges falling upon the rock have been swallowed up. They shall hear my words, for they have prevailed, as when the thickness of the earth is broken up upon the ground, our bones are scattered by the side of hell. But O to thee, O Lord, Lord, are my eyes, in thee have I put my trust, take not away my soul. Keep me from the snare, which they have laid for me, and from the stumbling blocks of them that work iniquity. The wicked shall fall in his net, I am alone until I pass. Their judges, their rulers, or chiefs, quickly vanish and perish, like ships dashed against the rocks, and swallowed up by the waves. Let them then hear my words, for they are powerful and will prevail, or, as it is in the Hebrew, for they are sweet. I am alone, singularly protected by the Almighty, until I pass all their nets and snares. Voce me. A prayer of David in extremity of danger. Of understanding for David. A prayer when he was in the cave. Kings, I cried to the Lord with my voice I made supplication to the Lord. In his sight I pour out my prayer, and before him I declare my trouble. When my spirit failed me, then thou knewest my paths. In this way wherein I walked, they have hidden a snare for me. I looked on my right hand, and beheld, and there was no one that would know me. Flight hath failed me, and there is no one that hath regard to my soul. I cried to thee, O Lord, I said, thou art my hope, my portion in the land of the living. Attend to my supplication, for I am brought very low. Deliver me from my persecutors, for they are stronger than I. Bring my soul out of prison, that I may praise thy name, the just wait for me, until thou reward me. Domini, exaudi. The psalmist in tribulation calleth upon God for his delivery. The seventh penitential psalm. Hear, O Lord, my prayer, give ear to my supplication in thy truth, hear me in thy justice. And enter not into judgment with thy servant, for in thy sight no man living shall be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he hath brought down my life to the earth. He hath made me to dwell in darkness as those that have been dead of old, and my spirit is in anguish within me, my heart within me is troubled. I remembered the days of old, I meditated on all thy works, I meditated upon the works of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands to thee, my soul is as earth without water unto thee. Hear me speedily, O Lord, my spirit hath fainted away. Turn not away thy face from me, lest I be like unto them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for in thee have I hoped. Make the way known to me, wherein I should walk, for I have lifted up my soul to thee. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, to thee have I fled, teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me into the right land. For thy name's sake, O Lord, thou wilt quicken me in thy justice. Thou wilt bring my soul out of trouble, and in thy mercy thou wilt destroy my enemies. And thou wilt cut off all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. Benedictus Dominus. The prophet praiseth God, and groweth to be delivered from his enemies. No worldly happiness is to be compared with that of serving God. A Psalm of David against Goliath. Blessed be the Lord my God, who teacheth my hands to fight, and my fingers to war. My mercy, and my refuge, my support, and my deliverer, my protector, and I have hoped in him, who subdueth my people under me. Lord, what is man, that thou art made known to him? Or the son of man, that thou makest account of him? Man is like to vanity, his days pass away like a shadow. Lord, bow down thy heavens and descend, touch the mountains and they shall smoke. Send forth lightning, and thou shalt scatter them, shoot out thy arrows, and thou shalt trouble them. Put forth thy hand from on high, take me out, and deliver me from many waters, from the hand of strange children, whose mouth hath spoken vanity, and their right hand is the right hand of iniquity. To thee, O God, I will sing a new canticle, on the psaltery and an instrument of 10 strings I will sing praises to thee. who givest salvation to kings, who hast redeemed thy servant David from the malicious sword. Deliver me, and rescue me out of the hand of strange children, whose mouth hath spoken vanity, and their right hand is the right hand of iniquity, whose sons are as new plants in their youth, their daughters decked out, adorned round about after the similitude of a temple, their storehouses full, flowing out of this into that. Their sheep fruitful and young, abounding in their goings forth, their oxen fat. There is no breach of wall, nor passage, nor crying out in their streets. They have called the people happy, that hath these things, but happy is that people whose God is the Lord. Exalt abote, Deus. A psalm of praise, to the infinite majesty of God. I will extol thee, O God my King, and I will bless thy name forever, yea, forever and ever. Every day I will bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever, yea, forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and of his greatness there is no end. Generation and generation shall praise thy works, and they shall declare thy power. They shall speak of the magnificence of the glory of thy holiness, and shall tell thy wondrous works. And they shall speak of the might of thy terrible acts, and shall declare thy greatness. They shall publish the memory of the abundance of thy sweetness, and shall rejoice in thy justice. The Lord is gracious and merciful, patient and plenteous in mercy. The Lord is sweet to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. Let all thy works, O Lord, praise thee, and let thy saints bless thee. They shall speak of the glory of thy kingdom, and shall tell of thy power, to make thy might known to the sons of men, and the glory of the magnificence of thy kingdom. Thy kingdom is a kingdom of all ages, and thy dominion endureth throughout all generations. The Lord is faithful in all his words, and holy in all his works. The Lord lifteth up all that fall, and setteth up all that are cast down. The eyes of all hope in thee, O Lord, and thou givest them meat in due season. Thou openest thy hand, and fist with blessing every living creature. The Lord is just in all his ways, and holy in all his works. The Lord is nigh unto all them that call upon him, to all that call upon him in truth. He will do the will of them that fear him, and he will hear their prayer, and save them. The Lord keepeth all them that love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless thy holy name for ever, yea, for ever and ever. Lauda, anima. We are not to trust in men, but in God alone. Alleluia, of Agius and Zacharias. Praise the Lord, O my soul, in my life I will praise the Lord, I will sing to my God as long as I shall be. Put not your trust in princes, in the children of men, in whom there is no salvation. His spirit shall go forth, and he shall return into his earth, in that day all their thoughts shall perish. Blessed is he who hath the God of Jacob for his helper, whose hope is in the Lord his God. Who made heaven and earth, the sea, and all things that are in them. Who keepeth truth for ever, who executeth judgment for them that suffer wrong, who giveth food to the hungry. The Lord looseth them that are fettered, the Lord enlighteneth the blind. The Lord lifteth up them that are cast down, the Lord loveth the just. The Lord keepeth the strangers, he will support the fatherless and the widow, and the ways of sinners he will destroy. The Lord shall reign forever, thy God, O Sion, unto generation and generation. Laudate Dominum. An exhortation to praise God for his benefits. Praise ye the Lord, because Psalm is good, to our God be joyful and comely praise. The Lord buildeth up Jerusalem, he will gather together the dispersed of Israel. Who healeth the broken of heart, and bindeth up their bruises. Who telleth the number of the stars, and calleth them all by their names. Great is our Lord, and great is his power, and of his wisdom there is no number. The Lord lifteth up the meek, and bringeth the wicked down even to the ground. Sing ye to the Lord with praise, sing to our God upon the harp. Who covereth the heaven with clouds, and prepareth rain for the earth. Who maketh grass to grow on the mountains, and herbs for the service of men. Who giveth to beasts their food, and to the young ravens that call upon him. He shall not delight in the strength of the horse, nor take pleasure in the legs of a man. The Lord taketh pleasure in them that fear him, and in them that hope in his mercy. Lauda, Jerusalem. The Church is called upon to praise God for His peculiar graces and favors to His people. In the Hebrew, this psalm is joined to the foregoing. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem, praise thy God, O Zion. Because He hath strengthened the bolts of thy gates, He hath blessed thy children within thee. Who hath placed peace in thy borders, and filleth thee with the fat of corn. Who sendeth forth His speech to the earth, His word runneth swiftly. Who giveth snow like wool, scattereth mists like ashes. He sendeth His crystal like morsels, who shall stand before the face of His cold. He shall send out His word, and shall melt them, His wind shall blow, and the waters shall run. Who declareth His word to Jacob, His justices and His judgments to Israel. He hath not done in like manner to every nation, and His judgments He hath not made manifest to them. Alleluia. He sendeth His crystal, that is, His ice. Some understand it of hail, which is, as it were, ice, divided into particles or morsels. Laudate Dominum Decaelis. All creatures are invited to praise their Creator. Alleluia. Praise ye the Lord from the heavens, praise ye Him in the high places. Praise ye Him, all His angels, praise ye Him, all His hosts. Praise ye Him, O sun and moon, praise Him, all ye stars and light. Praise Him, ye heavens of heavens, and let all the waters that are above the heavens praise the name of the Lord. For He spoke, and they were made, He commanded, and they were created. He hath established them forever, and for ages of ages, He hath made a decree, and it shall not pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, ye dragons, and all ye deeps, fire, hail, snow, ice, stormy winds which fulfill His word, mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars, beasts and all cattle, serpents and feathered fowls. Kings of the earth and all people, princes and all judges of the earth, young men and maidens, let the old with the younger, praise the name of the Lord, for His name alone is exalted. The praise of Him is above heaven and earth, and He hath exalted the horn of His people. A hymn to all His saints, to the children of Israel, a people approaching to Him. Alleluia. Cantate Domino. The Church is particularly bound to praise God. Alleluia. Sing ye to the Lord a new canticle, let His praise be in the Church of the Saints. Let Israel rejoice in Him that made him, and let the children of Zion be joyful in their King. Let them praise His name in choir, let them sing to Him with the timbrel and the psaltery. For the Lord is well pleased with His people, and He will exalt the meek unto salvation. The saints shall rejoice in glory, they shall be joyful in their beds. The high praise of God shall be in their mouth, and two-edged swords in their hands, to execute vengeance upon the nations, chastisements among the people, to bind their kings with fetters, and their nobles with manacles of iron. To execute upon them the judgment that is written, this glory is to all His saints. Alleluia. Laudate Dominum in Sanctis. An exhortation to praise God with all sorts of instruments. Alleluia. Praise ye the Lord in His holy places, praise ye Him in the firmament of His power. Praise ye Him for His mighty acts, praise ye Him according to the multitude of His greatness. Praise Him with sound of trumpet, praise Him with psaltery and harp. Praise Him with timbrel and choir, praise Him with strings and organs. Praise Him on high-sounding cymbals, praise Him on cymbals of joy, let every spirit praise the Lord. Alleluia.